Christmas episode. Bah humbug! The Grinch is in today. I got some shit of the weeks for people. I'm going to be the Grinch. Knocker will be the Santa.
Yes.
Ray will be that Mexican elf you pick up on the sidewalk. And we'll bring you all your Christmas joy this Monday episode.
He's the Home Depot elf.
He's the Homes elf. He's the Homes elf, eh? You find the Homes elf at Home Depot.
The Homes elf.
The Homes elf.
What's the Homes elf at the Home Depot?
That's as high as my voice gets.
Telling you. All right, guys, welcome back. Those special Monday episode. For those that are watching Monday Night Football right now and the Lions taking it to the Saints that no one cares about. So we're glad to bring you a show. And, again, we'll have it up on iTunes for you by tomorrow. Also, we'll have the video up on YouTube. Great show. We're going to have a fun show today. We've got a lot of stuff going on. Knocker's dressed up, as you see.
Pumped up,
we've got some presents on the table. We'll open up later. Also, we want you guys to chime in at sportscast_THN on Twitter. Please tweet us. Call the show.
Follow my ass on Twitter.
Thank you. 818-435-8423 is the number. Please call us. Let us know. We got a couple subjects we want you guys to chime in on. We've already got some people chiming on Twitter, so we appreciate it. Coming up in the last hour, we got the
Ask him what you want him to tweet.
That's what I'm just going to go right now.
I'm sorry.
Jeez, you know, like, geez, you haven't been doing this 4 years. Coming up in the last hour of the show, we're going to have the 15 worst Christmas gifts that you can give. And I also want to know, what is the worst gift you've ever got on Christmas? Like, what is that bad gift? You're like, Jesus Christ,
like,
really?
You're like, what the hell?
Like, what the hell is this, Grandma?
And your three favorite Christmas movies.
And your three favorite Christmas movies, because your three favorite Christmas movies are going to tell.
You're right over there?
You
all right?
They're going to tell a lot about you.
Yes.
Those three Christmas movies that you like, they're going to tell a lot about who you are. We're going to talk about that in the last hour. But first,
we don't want no Debbie Does Santa, all right? We don't want any of that.
Yeah, Irish.
Who watches adult films on Christmas Day with the family?
There's actually a listener named Irish on the show. I would think that he'd probably chime in with.
A weekend with Rudolph.
Come on. We don't need that.
Jesus. My God.
The reason he's got a red nose.
Chaps is like, baby, let's do it. All right.
The reason he's got a red nose.
Talking Rudolph, baby. All right, we'll talk some Christmas joy later in the show. We got a lot going on in Sports Knocker. Huge weekend in the NFL. We're going to get to the Odell Beckham, Josh Norman fiasco.
Playoffs are starting to shake out.
Yeah, we've got baseball bats on the field, though, in New York. Yeah, so we'll talk about that. Also coming up in the show, a few injuries. Cardinals suffering a big one today.
Devastating
injury on their defense. We'll talk about that. DeAndre Hopkins screaming at a ref saying F you to a ref, and I like it. I'm going to go off. I like what DeAndre Hopkins did over the weekend.
Whoa.
Some other injuries. Okay, other injuries going on. Marcus Mariota, Peyton Manning saying this report that Ian Rapoport of NFL.com put out is bullshit and insulting. But I actually think it's quite true. And we've actually got a man in studio, Corey Fine, my buddy from last week. He's been here before.
Woo!
He's a Denver native, and so I want to talk to you about that, Peyton Manning, the atmosphere around Denver right now, because – for the past three games, you're like, yeah, Brock looks great. First half, he looks awesome. And second half, they can't do anything.
He looked great Sunday in the first half.
Yeah.
And he might be injured. I mean, he took a couple shots.
Like,
you are one pathetic loser.
You can't do anything. Like, what is wrong with you? I don't understand. So talk about that. Also coming up on the show, we got our bonehead of the week. We've also got our week 16. Week 16.
No, it's sad, man.
Week 16. I just
barely got started.
My God. You know, so sick of it's every time.
Well, everybody hurts. Sometimes everybody cries.
You know, not only is this NFL season over, but the Cowboys season was over like 4 weeks ago.
That's Jerry Jones's ringtone now.
Yes. Hey, Jerry, someone's calling you. You might want to pick that up, Jerry.
Why, Jerry. Thank you. Why, thank you. I'll pick that up.
Do you know who the quarterback is this weekend?
Who?
Kellen Moore.
Who?
Oh, Boise State.
Wait, who?
That's right, Corey. Kellen Moore. Yeah.
Oh, my God. Who the hell cares?
Hey, you know what your coach said about him, though, was, he's not that athletic, but he always seems to make a play.
Oh my God, who the hell cares?
Jason Garrett can make a dirty Sanchez sound positive. Right?
I know.
I'm just saying.
It's true.
I like Mark Sanchez.
I've always liked a dirty Sanchez.
Oh, wait, what?
There's a sound drop right there.
That's good.
I mean, really, Jason Garrett is the most upbeat, politically correct, nice guy coach ever.
He's a whipped bitch.
Ever.
He's a whipped
little
bitch.
Well, he's Jerry's boy, and Jerry's going to carry the curse. But the look on Jerry's face after the game was just fantastic.
For the first time in so long, Knucker, I rooted for the Cowboys to lose this week.
Really?
Like, draft pick, baby! Get number two! We're only behind the Chargers. Thank God the Chargers won. I mean, we're right there for number one pick.
You know what, though? You know what this proves?
Maybe Jerry's smart. He's like, you know, we're going to get Kellen fucking who guys know more. And we're going to throw him in the quarterback. We'll lose the last two games.
You know what this proves, though? Really? On a deeper scale, it proves money can't buy happiness. This guy's as rich as you can be. He can do anything, go anywhere, buy anything, do whatever he wants. He's one of the greatest successes in U.S. history. But dude ain't happy because he ain't winning. Oh. Right? I mean, am I right or am I wrong?
You're right. Absolutely
you're right. Right.
The one thing he wants most is to win a championship and
you
be
gotta
a Super
love
Bowl
the man's
champion.
Passion.
Absolutely. Got no problem with that. It's just the ego got in the way. He had the right coach. He'd probably have five rings by now if he wasn't so.
And we're spending way too much time on a team that is not even relevant in the playoffs.
Ooh. Oh, my God. Who the hell cares?
That's a man that's hurting right now.
Okay.
I
can
deep
you feel,
feeling
yeah,
deep
I'm,
pain.
Can you feel it right
just
now?
Had a bad day. Take a walk. Sing a sad song.
Yes. You know how many times in the last 2 months I've actually wanted you to play that song when it counted? Yeah. When it counted. Like when I needed it and you weren't there. But when it calls for it now you play it. Yeah.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Hey, quick question for both of you. A little fun fact. Who did Jerry Jones originally, who was the first team Jerry Jones originally tried to buy? Do you guys know that?
Oh, Knocker might know that.
No, I don't.
Okay, you want to take a guess? Yeah. Do you want to take a guess?
The Chiefs.
And...
Josh? Back in the day, I couldn't even take it. Just give it to me.
Okay, so he actually tried to buy the Chargers.
The Chargers?
Is that right?
Yeah, and guess who was the initial backer he tried to get funds from to buy the team was Jimmy Hoffa.
Jimmy Hoffa?
Yeah, and his father told him not to do it, and then he ended up going into the oil industry, and that's where he made all his money, and then he bought the Dallas Cowboys.
Oh, we got the Colonel.
Are you talking
online?
About out of college?
No, we got the Colonel.
He just dropped the Steve, whatever his
the
name
Colonel.
Is.
The Colonel. I'm going to bring you in with this because we love you. Here we go.
America, fuck yeah.
How you like that?
Merry Christmas, motherfucker.
Yeah! Love you, buddy. I miss you so much, man.
How's it going?
Dude, fantastic, man.
Dude, how are you, sir? Again, we're talking to Colonel on Twitter. He serves our country. We love him to death. He is seriously one of the founding fathers of the Sportscast family.
Absolutely.
And Colonel, you keep spreading the word. But you just put our sticker out in the Pentagon.
I know. I saw that.
Yeah, I was back there for a business trip, and no better place to stick a big, fat sticker than right in the courtyard of the Pentagon.
That's awesome. I hope you don't
so
get in trouble
cool.
for that. Or
you
like,
know how many
you know?
People I showed that? Look!
I know.
Look at this, man! Look!
Yeah, Knocker was right, ran. Colonel, and I know you're a recently married man. Is that correct?
That is correct, Whoa! Sir. I am very happily married.
Mazel tov.
Yeah, seriously. I'm so happy
yeah,
for you, man.
It.
She's
Thanks.
A beautiful woman. I know you've had some pictures out on Facebook and stuff, and she's a beautiful lady. I couldn't be happier for you. You know, you're just a good human being, and we appreciate everything you do for us, the country, and you're just a good guy, man.
You know
what was
really cool? You put out that picture that 2 years ago, the
Yeah, where
it,
he came
the
over
images?
Down. Oh, my.
Did he
the
take
funny,
a picture of us with the jerseys that he gave
that.
Us?
No matter how long we do this show or when we stop, that show will always be in my memory forever, Colonel, when you came
awesome,
down,
man.
You were awesome.
You put that on the Time Warp the other day, and I just had a little chuckle to myself. You know, it was that was fantastic.
It was. It was good stuff, man.
I can't pass up the Christmas show without giving you guys a shout-out, giving a call-in, and wishing you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and, go Caps.
All right,
go
man.
Caps.
Hey.
You're still hanging in,
No,
huh?
Dude, Caps got, like, the best record in the NHL right now. Is that correct, Colonel?
Oh,
yeah,
Colonel's
it's
up.
Pretty damn close.
Yeah.
They're up there.
The Colonel's
there.
A hockey fan.
Oh, Colonel's huge. He lives and dies with the Caps. It's so sad, this man.
Colonel.
He just knows every. He knows, even if it's good right now, Colonel, you know they're going to choke in the playoffs, right?
Oh, don't listen to him, Colonel.
First round. First round. Every time.
First round, game seven, overtime.
That TJ Oshie sure does look good, though, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely. You know, hey, there's a lot of good stuff going on in D.C. sports, except for the Wizards and the Redskins. But, you know,
hey,
Colonel, I got one thing to say. Blast this for me right now.
You like that? You like that?
Huh?
I need to hear that. This is now. See, this
do
is
that
my
again. Yeah. Blast it for me real quick. Here we go, Renee.
You like that? You like that?
Oh, what do you think about that?
Yeah, you like that? Bryce Harper is gonna rule you all. I love it.
Okay, now this is what I want to see. Okay, 42 combined Blacktop and Apache attack helicopters.
Okay,
right, playing that at top volume as they bomb the you know what out of ISIS. You like that? You like that, ISIS? You like that?
Yeah. Just like nonstop.
They have a movie like that. It's called Apocalypse Now.
Right. That's what I'm saying. That's well, it. That's where I'm drawing the image
you know
from.
How
that's
paint,
what I want
you know
to hear.
They paint stuff on the bombs. Did someone put you like that on one of those fucking like bombs that? For ISIS? Just drop it on them, man. Hey, Colonel, dude, we love you. Dude. I'm so happy to hear from you, man. I'm glad everything's going good. Congratulations and a very Merry
fantastic.
Christmas. And anytime you come
thank
out
you,
here,
sir.
You're always welcome
hey.
Here.
I still got to get a bottle of moonshine, and you know, out here in Kentucky, I'll get you a bottle of bourbon as well, and we'll have a good time. I promise.
I right. love that man.
Hey, Colonel, you have a Merry Christmas, and we love you to death, brother. You have a good one.
You guys too.
All right,
cheers,
brother. Thank you. I love that. You know what? Another just for him being.
America, fuck yeah! So lick my butt, suck on my bones. America, fuck yeah! What you gonna do when we come for you now?
Man is not only a colonel, he worked in the Pentagon. He put our sticker on the Pentagon wall. He yes. might be like decommissioned after this.
Right.
I was afraid for
he's
his
risking
life.
His
I was
career.
Like, is that like you're just like you're tagging on the Pentagon?
You're tagging the Pentagon.
And now I'm gonna get like a letter from the fucking government says, "Dear Sportscast Entertainment LLC, you are now
you owe us $10,000 for cleanup."
Yeah, exactly. Me and Knocker out there in our yellow jumpsuits or whatever, clean up the Pentagon stickers.
Great. No, I'm going to try to get deported.
Right,
to
you better have
now.
Your birth certificate.
Yeah, seriously.
Yeah, seriously. All right. Hey, Colonel Man, big
thank
shout out.
So
thank
much.
You for calling. 818-435-8423. Again, tweet the show at sportscast_THM. We got, again, a lot of football coming up. We'll talk college. We'll talk Christmas in just a little bit. Shot of the week coming up at the top of the hour, the second break. We got Knocker's Song of the Week. Opening up some gifts. Corey's in the house. Renee's, I don't know what he's doing over there. He's sometimes on the ones and twos, sometimes ones, sometimes twos.
Fours and fives, whatever.
Fours and fives, who knows. We'll be back. And here we go. Let's get to the NFL Knocker. Huge news coming up this week. A lot of injuries, a lot of big games. Some baseball bats on the football field?
Seriously, what the hell?
What is that?
All right, before we jump too deep into this, we've got longtime listener Douglas Logson at
I love
375.
Dougie Fresh.
Right?
Dougie Fresh, yeah. I like
poor
him.
Guy, he's a Bears fan.
Oh,
he's a Bears fan.
Hey, Dougie,
stop Bears.
I picked your Bears this weekend.
Oh, I didn't.
I didn't. Anyway, he says, wait, there's still football? Oh, yeah. Thing. Life of a Bears fan. Hashtag season's over. Hashtag let's talk Star Wars.
Oh my God, who the hell cares?
It is rough in Chicago,
speaking
man.
Speaking of Star Wars, we'll talk about that when we come back. I saw the movie over the weekend. There's a lot of women that just are like, right now after that. They're like, yeah. Let's hear it again. All right. Let's get into the NFL, guys.
I love this show.
I do, too. Your hat says it all right now. Right? Ball humbug at the top there. Throw Matt's back on here, Renee. All right. Over the weekend, Knocker, huge game between the Giants and Panthers. Big story that came out over the weekend on Sunday. Odell Beckham Jr. going at Josh Norman, probably the best corner in the NFL right now for the Panthers, trying to keep that unbeaten streak alive. Started out with Odell Beckham dropping a huge potential touchdown pass. If you could throw it up here. The touchdown pass, if you can, Renee, from Odell Beckham. The one where he dropped it. Kind of set the whole precedent for the game here, Knocker. You can check out again on our YouTube channel right now on Ustream. I just throw out the video clips as we talk about it. Knocker, as a former receiver, and a very good receiver were.
Thank you.
As you know, the ball hits your hands, both hands. You catch the ball, and especially with that. That set up the game right there for Odell Beckham.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, it's not – he's a lot like Dez Bryant. Makes the fantastic catch. Makes the catch that you just don't believe that he makes. But, dude, you got to catch them all.
Right.
That was very important. You got to catch them all. There's no excuse for a lack of concentration on a gift touchdown.
And as we know,
the easiest touchdown you can have all year.
Odell Beckham already only played 12 games last year, already on the cover of Madden
right.
because of his catch. So this guy's already been put up to a level that most football players have to earn to get there.
Right.
This guy's only had 1 year. Now, he's come out. He's kind of a showboater. We've seen the touchdown
dances.
You're not a fan of it.
No.
Now, just to set a little bit.
For that reason right there.
And set the
stage.
Why
aren't you dancing on the drop ball?
You know why? Because you decided to wear Christmas light shoes before the game, Knocker. Christmas light shoes, bro? Corey, okay,
can we
Corey.
Just play football?
Yeah, you're a hockey guy.
Oh man,
you see
yeah,
a guy
exactly.
come out in warm-ups with some Christmas light skates.
He'd get fucking
Are you not
knocked out.
Deck that guy?
No, he'd get knocked
like,
out.
Like you're decking the dude that wears the Christmas light skates, right? Like that's just about.
You got knocked the fuck out, man.
You got knocked the fuck out.
Beyond. So Odell, you're asking for it from the beginning,
right?
Right.
Right.
Okay, so then he goes and drops the pass earlier in the game. Now, the two have been jostling all game. Mm-hmm. Josh Norman and Odell Beckham going at it all game. Now, play comes up later in the game, third quarter, Renee. Now, throw that one you had up at the first here, the cheap shot. Now, this play is really mind-boggling to me. If you haven't seen this, go to our site. We had the video up here. Odell Beckham taking a full-on head run.
From behind.
From behind.
Ooh,
on
what
George,
a man.
Josh Norman, we got two different views. Thank you, Renee, putting up very good there. Ooh, wow, putting up very good there, Renee. I like how I put that up there.
I like that.
I'll tell you one thing. If that shit happened in the NHL,
really?
I mean, a lineman would have torn Odell Beckham's head off.
Yes. You can see the full video. He takes literally a 10-yard run at Josh Norman, tries to go headhunting, leading with his helmet like a bullet. Luckily, just grazes him, misses him. Now comes down today. He's going to go ahead and get a one-game suspension.
Good.
At the time, he should have been ejected.
Absolutely. He should have gotten this game suspension on top of it.
I agree. I think he should be out for the season. And this, if let's just see, Knocker. What if he knocked him out?
Oh yeah.
How serious is it? Like,
yeah.
You know when a kid
Broke
gets in
his
trouble?
Jaw.
Oh, like the kid. Oh, he kind of got in trouble. So maybe it's not as worse as it could have been. This could have been really bad.
He breaks his jaw on something like that.
This is going to make me sound old, but there's no respect in the game. That's why
right.
in hockey, you don't see
a
lot of
point.
This stuff
right.
because of the fact that if you... Okay, you guys are both Kings fans, so God forbid someone went and laid out Jeff Carter or Anze Kopitar, immediately, within seconds,
yes.
there would be repercussions
yes.
for that because there has to be repercussions. And until in the NFL, there's that... form of respect for your teammates. I just feel like there's not that passion for
even
team
in hockey.
Play.
If you do something like, there might even be repercussions from your own team.
Yes,
for doing something really
yes.
cheap and,
yes.
and out of the game. You know,
you're right.
Stuff
but,
is great,
but let me just throw this at you because it just kind of makes it a little harder to swallow. Because he did come back and make the game tying touchdown catch.
That's why he should have been out of the game.
I know, but that is it. Like if you're Coughlin, you're kind of put in a tough spot here. Because it's like, yeah, your dude effed up, and he shouldn't have done that, but he also did also tie the game for you.
Oh, no, I understand.
You know what I mean?
Keeping
like,
him in there, absolutely.
That's a tough spot as a coach to be with, where your player, you know, basically does one thing bad, but he also saves his ass. Like DeSean Jackson the week before. I mean, the guy effs up by trying to run that punt back and then
right.
scores the game-tying touchdown.
Well, sure. I mean, if they don't kick him out, you leave him in the game. That's all you can do as a coach. But my question is, if this had happened on Las Vegas Boulevard, right?
Yeah.
Some dude takes a 15-yard run at somebody and headbutts him.
It's on.
You're going to jail.
Yeah.
You're going to jail for assault. Why is that not assault?
That's a good point.
Why? Why are you? Why is that okay?
If even a helmet, in hockey. If a helmet's considered a weapon, right. Which it is now in the NFL, you right. can't lead with the helmet. This is a full-on. This isn't something that like a player caught the ball over the middle. It's a split-second decision by the cornerback.
Right. The DB.
This is a dude looking to line up. The dude that's been frustrating right. him all game.
You have that penalty targeting, right? Well, the defensive backs are in a real tough spot because they're trying to make a tackle, and it's bang bang.
Yeah.
This was thought about. This was.
Is this like headhunting in baseball?
Absolutely.
Renee, would
absolutely.
You?
Yeah, I'd agree with that. Yeah, totally.
Like, so if a guy goes headhunting, you know he's. Can you tell if a guy's deliberate? How can you tell in baseball if someone's deliberately headhunting? Is there a way?
The situation.
Because football's yeah. more. Okay, I see the guy running 10 yards. You it's
got,
obvious.
You got a guy pinpoint control who hasn't thrown four
or
balls
the, guy
the whole
hit
the game.
Home, or the guy no, hit the home
yeah,
run.
No, all
three
of a sudden, you know, it's in a situation where it calls for one and it happens. What I'm getting to is the NHL. Has policed this now. If you yeah. if you do something like that in the NHL, you're, I mean McSorley and what you're going to court.
Yeah,
you're gonna get sued as if this happened on a sidewalk in the public. You just because you have a on a football uniform and you're on a field of play, that's assault with intent to injure. I'm sorry, but that's exactly what that was.
Not only that, I mean, if you're the Giants, you got to almost suspend Odell Beckham yourself because not only did he just make your franchise look horrible, now he's out for probably the biggest game of the season, which you're going to play right. the – what, the – who the Giants play next week?
Give me a second.
I'm not sure who the Giants play because I think it's Washington, Philly. But, again, you're out next week for one of the biggest games that you can play. And if you're the Giant, I mean, this is just a horrible, horrible situation here.
The Vikings.
Oh, Vikings. Okay, there you go. Out for a huge game against the Vikings.
Yes.
And then Knocker. But now the new news comes out. A couple hours ago, we put it up on our site again, sportscastlife.com. Now there was, I guess, baseball bats that Carolina Panthers had on, pregame warm-ups. The videos are on our site, guys. Go check them out if you haven't seen them. You actually see Panthers, I guess he's an assistant coach or someone that's on the team.
Right.
Actually has a bat on the field, and as the Giants are coming out for warm-ups, he's patting the bat, talking crap to Odell Beckham as they're coming out. Then you also see another clip comes out where actually Josh Norman is holding the bat on the field.
He should have been suspended on the spot.
Now Odell's coming out, and he's saying this is the reason this all started. My question is to basically all three of you. Does that make a difference? Because the Panthers have come out and said, hey, this is something we do before all pregame warm-ups. It's something that motivates us. It's called laying the wood or something to that relevant. My thing is, I don't think there should be baseball bats. I think that it's
not on
I think
the field.
That it's okay that you have okay. Yeah,
you
want to
run out. You
be in the locker room. Be in the locker room with your bats.
But even if you run
you're
out,
you're bringing well, out pre-game. A weapon, and you're coming out, and you're intimidating the other team with a weapon.
Yeah,
that's like the Dodgers coming out before a Dodgers Giants game, and warm-ups be like. Yeah, that's right. We got some bats, so we're going to beat
or
you.
Like full like, pads or something like that.
As
like
much
running
as I
into
like,
each other.
I like the Panthers, and I like this whole.
They're getting carried away.
But they're getting a little carried away right now.
Yes, they are.
You can't bring a baseball bat out in the field.
No, I don't mind running it out, laying the wood, because that's what we do. Somebody runs out with it,
but then you
lay it behind the bench, and it stays there.
You look at the videos, it's a total intimidation.
Yes.
It's all intimidation factor.
So as soon as that happened on the field, the refs should have thrown that guy out of the game for holding a bat. On the baseball field.
I agree, man.
What period. Done.
This just doesn't need to be in the NFL.
Nope.
So,
okay.
All right.
But at the same time, I'm just saying bravo to Carolina. Like, they got him out of the game mentally before that shit
Very
even
good
started.
Point.
And as a hockey player, like, that's what you do.
Dude.
You go for the mental aspect.
Why do you have that sixth defenseman?
Yeah.
to F with the big star, right?
What Odell Beckham should have done, and I look at it as he was so unprofessional because as a professional athlete, you focus. You use that as motivation.
Josh Norman
and you
did
go
his
up
job.
There
yep.
and I thought Josh Norman is if because now people are gonna take note of that, and I guarantee when they play Minnesota this next game, whoever's covering or if they make it to the playoffs, let's say. And Odell gets another chance. Whoever's covering him is going to get in his head. They're going to talk crap.
Other teams are going to use this to their benefit. I agree.
Here's my problem with this,
Corey.
Okay, I understand what he was doing. I understand the motivation, and it worked. Okay? But here's my problem. As soon as that bat came on the field, the referees should have thrown him out of the game. Period. And wait, let me finish. Okay? Because right now, there are some high school kids, and there's a high school team, that if they're willing to attack a referee and now they've seen a professional player bring a bat onto the field during introductions to intimidate the other team, and nobody threw the guy out, well, I guess it's okay.
I think the refs are just as much fault. Yeah.
Right? Let's bring an Uzi.
No, let's not get ridiculous.
Why not?
I think the refs are at fault for not for letting the game be out of control. They should have controlled this when he got body slammed in the first quarter.
Okay.
When Josh Norman body slammed him.
But
so,
both
I mean,
of you guys can agree that the refs this year in the NFL
are just the
worst. All around, bro.
I think they were even scared to kick him out.
No,
so.
I agree, man. All right. Yeah. So next up, we'll move on from there. I want to give a shout out to DeAndre Hopkins for saying what everybody wants to say to NFL refs. Turn this up for me. and have you heard this, Knocker? Here we go.
Oh, it's so good.
Here we go.
Hands on the clock to be played here in the third. We on the slant to DeAndre Hopkins.
What the fuck are you looking at?
Hands on the clock to be played here in the third. We on the slant to DeAndre Hopkins.
What the fuck are you looking at?
That is awesome.
But that's
DeAndre,
just the flow of the game.
I love you, DeAndre.
That's
I know, but
game.
It was for all the
That's
reps.
Awesome.
You just blowing all those calls. Thank you for just getting that caught on, Mike, because we're all thinking the same thing.
Right?
Like, we're
at
watching,
home,
yeah,
we're saying the
we're
same thing.
TV, we're saying, Ref, what the fuck are you looking at?
I think they just got some, like, employees from Foot Locker or something and decided to make them NFL reps.
Right? How many,
you know what I mean?
How many Detroit fans on the fake face mask were going,
what the fuck
are
you looking at?
What the fuck are you looking at? What the fuck face mask?
What the fuck are you looking at?
Oh, wait, what the fuck are you looking at? Des caught the ball!
It's just fun to say.
What the fuck are you looking at?
Just say like the black voice. What the fuck are you looking at?
Both of you can do that just so well. Let me try.
What the fuck are you looking at?
Yeah, see, it's like fun to do. Like, just say when next time you get when you get your Christmas gift this year, Christmas, and you don't like it.
What the fuck are you looking at?
Hey, Renee, I need to hear yours. Let's hear it.
What the fuck are you looking at?
Yeah, see, it's good. Oh, you had like a Mexican.
Ooh, that was like an horchata twist to it.
That's like a little Latina.
That's a Latino one?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
All right, Knockard. Huge injuries this weekend. Cardinals, the Honey Badger.
Yeah.
Done for the season. I think you got a picture of him going off in the cart here, Renee. Torn ACL. Did Bruce Arians leave his starter in too long?
I don't believe in that crap.
I wrote this on sportscastlife.com today. I believe he did. They were in a blowout game. I think it's time to take him. I really didn't see it necessarily.
Did this happen in the fourth quarter or
third?
It did.
Fourth quarter, 3 minutes left.
Oh, then yeah, they should have been out. Your whole first team should have been out.
Right?
Absolutely.
You're up by more than two touches. You got
to. That is dumb coaching. What is he going to learn in the last 3 minutes of a blowout?
And right now, I might have picked the Cardinals over Panthers in that NFC title game. I like Panthers now. I think Honey Badger's a point in betting. I think he's that valuable.
I agree.
You know what I mean? Like, that's a lot to say, because usually like a receiver or running back absence, like a half a point when it comes to betting. I think Honey Badger off the Cardinals is a definite point.
He definitely means just a lot, and they're going to have to change some schemes, and they're going to have to change some coverages. But I think they're a good enough defensive team that you know, they'll rally and
offense is
they'll
good still
be okay, and they're going to score enough
David
points.
David Johnson.
You know, I think.
Oh, David Johnson, a fantasy stud last week. My God. The running back for the Cardinals just went off 40 points last week. So
it's okay. It's okay. He went to Northern Iowa, and actually, they did not appreciate him on that team. But now he is fantastic, and I had him on fantasy.
Yeah, he killed it. He killed it.
Obviously,
yeah, he did. Marcus Mariota going down with the injury.
That's too bad.
Out with the MCL sprain for the rest of the season. Probably best he gets out of it sooner than later.
Sprain?
Yeah, nice. MCL sprain. So he's probably just getting done for the season. We'll come back next year.
No problem.
Peyton Manning says the Ian Rappaport story is bullshit and insulting. If you guys haven't heard, Ian Rappaport said earlier that Peyton Manning said he will not be behind Brock when I come back. I will not sit behind someone. That is rubbish.
Rubbish.
You know what, Peyton Manning? You should be sitting behind someone. I'm sorry to say. I know that Brock didn't score in that last half, but you probably wouldn't have either, and you probably would have had three interceptions before.
Well,
that.
He wouldn't have done what he did in the first half. What I noticed, what Brock Osweiler gives, and I'm no way. Calm down.
Yeah, Denver's gonna hate us right now. Denver's gonna absolutely. I mean,
everybody
I know Corey's
relax.
Hating this
There's
right
in
now.
No way, shape, or form am I comparing Brock Osweiler
no, we're not.
To
Thank
Peyton
you.
Manning in his prime.
Thank
There's
you.
No comparison, and he probably never will be what Peyton Manning was in his prime. But what he gave the Broncos was a little bit of young life, a little bit of zest. I watched him score a touchdown from 12 yards out that Peyton Manning never would have scored. He avoids the blitz. You know, he gets rid of the ball. Boom. you know, with more zip than Peyton is. I mean, it's right. The same reads, it's the same thing.
And dude put up 28 points in Pittsburgh.
You know, they scored the 28 points, and then they didn't score after. I think that's coaching. I think
play
that's
calling,
offensive coordinator. A
couple drops
lot,
as well.
A lot to do with that. And, you know, I don't have a problem with Brock playing quarterback, but, you know, Peyton.
Hey, you just Bengals and
Denver this week.
Yeah,
yes.
Big Monday night game.
Absolutely.
It's going to be huge.
Well, you guys hear, I mean, Peyton Manning's being investigated in the O.J. Simpson murder trial. You guys know that?
No. What?
Yeah, they're still looking for a slow-moving white Bronco.
Bad boys, bad boys.
Wait, hold on. I have to dig myself on that one.
That was good. That was pretty good.
Got a couple dings on that one. People like it.
Yeah, give one more. One more.
Someone out there is laughing.
Someone out there. English Linder.
Yeah, Sherry.
Yeah.
Hey, yeah. Renee.
That's my husband.
Yeah. It's American Bob effed up watching us on his big. He's like, that Renee guy. He knows his foot pump.
He's so funny.
He's so funny.
Renee, you'll have to give me that one before I leave because that will be a good one to say at the bars when I get back home in Colorado.
All right, Knocker. Real quick, we're going to get to break here. On the flip side, guys, we're going to get to our Week 16 Pigskin Pick'ems. Make sure you guys call the show 818-435-8423. Knocker, on Thursday night, the Rams fans were caught staying after the game after they lost, chanting, "Kroenke sucks." I mean, after they won on Thursday night against the Bucks, saying that their owner sucks, chanting it.
Of course they are. They're hurt.
Who's your pick to come to LA? Who's coming to LA is my question.
I didn't hear them crying when they stole our effing team from LA.
I don't want the Chargers. I don't want the Chargers. I don't want the Chargers.
No, Rams.
And I don't want the Raiders. So Rams. I guess I want the Rams.
Yes. LA Rams, baby. LA Rams. Bring them back.
It's a good looking team.
Roman
good
Gable forever.
Will they play in LA or they're going to play in Anaheim again, though?
No.
Because didn't they play in Anaheim for a while?
Why do you guys want more traffic?
So they play here in LA, right?
I don't think I need it. It's not going to really matter.
Rocky owns all the property around Hollywood Park, and that's where he's going to build it in Inglewood.
All right, we'll see.
Great.
We'll see.
Build it in Phillips Ranch.
We got week 16. Week 16 picks coming up after this. Also, Christmas presents to go around. Also, your guys, we want to get them in. Your top three Christmas movies you guys watched during the holidays and the worst gift you've ever been given on Christmas. We'll have all that and more coming up right after this.
a secret.
Welcome back. Sportscast special Christmas episode. Make sure you guys check us out on iTunes. Subscribe to the show. Spread the word, tell a friend. Also, guys, check us out on Podcast One, iHeartRadio, Stitcher Radio, the TuneIn Radio app. You guys can listen to us live. Also on Ustream. If you guys want to watch the show, it's always fantastic. We bring the madness. We'll have it on YouTube for you guys tomorrow. And again, we wish all the fans and sponsors and all you guys have made this show possible going on 5 years starting in 2016. Wow. So we really appreciate everyone out there. We're going on our 250th show here coming up. So really appreciate everybody. And again, we'll give our shots out here after the next break. So get those in. We've got a lot going out. 818-435-8423. Big shout out to the Colonel who called in earlier. Thank you very much. It was so good to hear from you. Tweet us at sportscast_THN. Right now, we're going to get into our Pigskin Pick'ems Week 16 on Stage 1. It's
Ed Sullivan. You guys have no idea who I just did, right?
I know who Ed Sullivan is.
Do you?
Yeah.
Right here on the stage.
Oh, my God. Who the hell cares?
That's right. We'll get back to football, guys. Don't worry. Bud Knocker likes to chime in. If you guys are new to the show, he also is a.k.a. my father, also a old grumpy old dude that no one likes to hear from. Again, guys, we've got to our Pigskin Pick'ems right now. I want to thank everybody. This has been a great Pigskin Pick'em League so far. We've got movers and shakers. $200 up for grabs right now in first place. Suck My Ditka takes the reins back.
Oh, wow.
Suck My Ditka with 146.
Well, tell him to suck my balls.
That's what Suck My Ditka is doing right now. Eagle Man, though. Wow. With a 14-win week, comes up in second place at 145. Ooh. My drunk friend Joey Leitzinger, 145, dropped down this week. One behind, he was tied. So again, we got two people, one behind the leader at 146. We have J-A-J-A-E-T-B-R-1. I don't know who that is, but again, 143, so that's fantastic.
Wow.
We got Min Archin at 143 as well. Cure Boys 2 at 143. And the Proto, drunk. Matt, can you play? Do you have that drunk guy of the week sound effect for Proto? Do you have that intro for just?
Hey, I remember when QuickTime here passed out in the booth, this booth, and we did stuff to him that you do to ladies, and we promise we never tell you. All the greatest moments of my life I spent right here in this booth. Maggie's first word, Bart jumping that canyon. Mr. Plow, all the greatest moments of my life. I gotta go pee. I don't want to get up.
Like Giants fan.
That guy is only three back of the leader.
Right?
You know, Proto.
What's cool is that we took a break, right? So Iris chimes in. Yeah. Break. Hashtag vodka time.
Yeah.
Proto chimes in. Think I'll join you. F it. I'm
See,
on vacation.
That's perfect right? for Proto right
and
there.
And then we got Douglas Austin. Has anyone had the score on the Detroit game? Ah, never mind. Hashtag sportscast. Way more entertaining than the NFL.
Thank you very much.
Attaboy.
Well, good.
It's up 21-3. Jesus Christ. All right, we got the Colonel again at 142. We got Mean.
Wow.
Mean Gene Bruce 360. I still want to know who Mean Gene Bruce 367 is.
That's a Palm Strings entry.
That a cute name, I just got to say. And so, again, winner gets $200. So, last 2 weeks, Knocker, as for us on the
Biting
show.
Biting it out.
Number one Mexican, me and Renee right now, both, we're at, oh, Renee's at 139 and I'm at 138.
Ooh.
What the hell? Ooh. The guy with the sound effects takes the lead of the show with 2 weeks left to Knocker. If anything, we have to beat the Mexican.
We have to.
We have to beat the sound effects guy.
Absolutely.
So, Knocker, I'm one behind him.
I love the
him.
Way you say that, like we're not.
Yeah.
I just love the way you do that.
The you Mexican are man. Racist.
Yeah. Yeah, but
he's more Mexican than we are.
You are racist.
You, sir, are racist.
You are racist.
Can I finish?
Knocker's only two back of the Mexican.
Can
Am I
please
I'm only two back and one behind you and two and behind him?
Yeah, so we're good. We got a race last 2 weeks. Who we got? We got a phone call? Yeah. All right, we got a phone call. Again, you guys want to call the show? 818-435-8423. Who we got in the line with the sports cast?
You got Tyler Golden.
Oh, Tyler Golden, what's going on,
nice.
Brother?
Nice.
What's happening?
What's going, dude? This is my old roommate from college.
Holy crap!
Freshman year, calling in from Mississippi. What's going on,
dude? The phone just rings and you come through. I mean, you just let anybody through.
That I know. That's how
we
bad
screen
this
our calls.
That's
man.
How bad this show is. We let any redneck call in from Mississippi.
Holy shit, the screening process over there.
It's tough, just, right?
It's nice.
Hey, you know us Californians, you know. Dude, Tyler, what's going on, brother? Man, I'm so glad to talk to you. I know you got two beautiful kids out there. I know, a daughter and a son. And, dude, how about that player from Ole Miss falling out of the building after some marijuana the other week, huh?
Dude, I thought you gave marijuana to your players so they would stay on their asses and play video games.
Right?
That's about freaking weed every day.
I know. We were going to get to this guy. What is his name from college football here?
In Kimdichi. Rob and Kimdichi.
Robert Kimdichi.
Kimdichi, right. There's two of them.
Now, if I'm not mistaken.
No, his brother supposedly did the hard stuff, the fake marijuana, and he did
Oh, the Bill Clinton
the real
marijuana?
Stuff.
The brother did the Bill Clinton marijuana, and he did the real stuff?
No, that synthetic stuff, the harder stuff.
Jesus. Salvia or whatever?
Well, Salvia?
That's why he couldn't move. Right?
Right, yeah. You had to go to the hospital. I said, that's not marijuana.
Are you serious? You went to the hospital on marijuana? That's fantastic.
Smoke weed every day.
It's that spice or whatever. I don't know.
Yeah,
that's new age.
That's right. That is. That's good stuff. So, Tyler, if I'm not mistaken, you're an Ole Miss fan. Is that not correct?
Oh, that's so opposite. I'm Mississippi State. I'm the rival.
You're the rival. So you were very happy to see this man fall out of a 4-story building.
Wow.
Well, I wasn't happy. You know, I wish him well, but it didn't hurt my feelings, you know. Crazy.
Good things happening for the Bulldogs down in Starkville, man. They're building that program up. They had a good thing going. Dak Prescott, I mean, they were hoping for a little bit better year this year, but, you know, considering what was happening 5 years ago down there, they've got a national program now, some national prominence, so that's kind of fun to see, right?
Yeah, no, it's unbelievable. Dak Prescott, he's an unbelievable kid, good guy, unbelievable quarterback. The problem is, you see rumors of your coach going to places like Maryland,
right?
And you're
right.
Golly, if Maryland's a step up from Mississippi State, we're going in the wrong way.
Yeah, when did the Terps become like a football powerhouse?
Well,
and then when Maryland comes out and says we weren't impressed by the guy, it hurts your feelings.
We weren't impressed. Maryland's not impressed.
Yeah, they come back. They're like, sorry guys, but he was a.
You are one pathetic loser.
Okay, so
Mississippi State has a shot at a national championship last year. They didn't get there. They had a great year this year. Maryland went 1 and who the fuck cares? And they're not impressed with your coach? Are you serious?
Right. That's a rumor reel. And then they took Mark Rich at Miami instead of Dan Mullen, which Mark Rich is super, super guy, and I guess they need that discipline in Miami. I don't know, but Dan Mullen got passed there, too. So how do you get passed up at a couple places and get, you know, open arms when you come back?
I don't know. That Mark Rich signing is just – could there be any more
weird,
just opposite
I don't see him being
things?
A hurricane. I
Mark
just
Rich, the nice guy, Christian-based guy. He does Christian movies, for God's sakes. And he's coaching at the U, the most notorious – Gangland University.
Not Jimmy Johnson
in the country.
You know?
How does this mix?
Yeah, you got to have Jimmy Johnson down there.
Yeah,
right.
You got to have that. I just don't see Mark doing that. But hey, Tyler. Well, since you got you on the line, man, I know you got. Is it snowing? How is it snow out there right now?
Where do you live in Mississippi?
I live in North Mississippi, just south of Memphis, and typically it's colder than now. But yeah, this week it's off and on, 60s, 70s, rainy. It's not bad.
I only
not
ask because I have family in Ocean Springs, Mississippi, so I grew up on that.
Okay, yeah. That's more south of here.
That's more redneck and backwoods.
I want to go on the red. I thought the slow Bronco joke was good. I liked it.
Thank you. Renee, I told you.
Well, Tyler, we're going to take you out with this music here for the Mississippis out there. And I'd like to know, what's your favorite Christmas movie? What are you guys watching at the Golden Household this evening?
Dude, I got two kids. I watch Frosty.
I want Frosty.
That's fantastic. That's fantastic. Hey, Tyler, dude, I'm so happy you called him in. I wish you nothing but the best, dude. And, you know, high school friend, college buddy. And
that's so cool.
I am. It's so happy. You got two beautiful babies.
I remember Tyler.
Yeah, Tyler's a good one. Good man.
Happy for you, too, buddy. Happy for you. I hope you'll let me call in again sometime.
Oh, well, you know, our screening process is pretty intense, as you found out. So.
Pretty lenient over here.
It might take you a couple of weeks to get to the front of the line, but keep on trying. Don't give up. Never give up.
That's great, dude. That's
all
great.
Right. Hey, you guys are doing Please a great job. In. Thanks for having me on.
Hey, Tyler, appreciate it, buddy. You have a good Christmas, man, and Happy New
you
Year.
You too, buddy.
All right, appreciate
Merry
it.
Merry Christmas.
Tyler, please call in. Nobody else does.
That was fantastic. I love our screening process, dude. I like that. You know,
you got a color.
Oh my god, dude, that guy's that guy's my. I haven't talked to him in forever.
You went to Damien?
So cool, yeah, man. Dude, he's my one of my great best friends through high school. I lived with him for my first year of college. You moved me into that apartment with him.
Absolutely.
We had some raging parties with Tyler Golden. I'm going to say that to you. It's a raging party. Let me search you. All right, guys. Let's get into week 16 picks here. Here we go. All right. Knocker, we got to make up like some 6 games on a leader.
Oh, Matt.
We got to beat Renee. That's more the important thing.
Oh, yeah, I'm motivated
whoever
now.
Whoever Renee beats, I'm putting it out right now. Right now.
Malort?
No, you know where I'm going with this.
Malort?
No, it's even better. It's even better. We have 2 weeks left, right? This is going to be good. Whoever loses between me and you to Renee, whoever has the worst score, or now I'm one back, you're two back.
Right.
Has to trade seats.
Oh, I'm not giving up my seat.
For 1 month.
No way.
The show. Yes.
Dude, I just got my camera fixed.
Are you not that confident? You can't beat a sound effect guy in football? Are you not that confident?
Knocker,
man?
It looks like I'm going to have to start teaching you how to use this stuff over here.
Oh, is it a bet? Is it a bet?
Yeah, of course.
Okay. We're going to do that.
Loser's off camera.
That means if whoever
wins. Loser goes off camera.
And runs the show. So that month is going to be.
Oh, that'll be a shit fest. Let me run it.
Oh my god. If loser has to go off camera.
Could you imagine Knocker running the show for a month?
I wouldn't tune
in. I don't think Tyler's gonna be watching anymore.
I'd have to write like directions down for
it. It's all Rocky Horror Picture Show all the time.
It's on a Brillo pad. I mean, my god.
I'm just a sweet transvestite.
That's what I'm talking about.
You guys might have to think of another bet because your father is just one of the more technically challenged men
I've met. Throw me on. Give him some hot in here, son. Give the Knocker some Lincoln or something. Get him going. Here we
that's
go.
What I'll talk about.
All right, Knocker. First game of the week, Thursday night football here. A game that we'll call the.
First, may I say something? Please.
You may interject.
F the Miami Dolphins. They could just suck my balls. What a poor ass, sorry ass representation of an NFL team this weekend.
I'll give you that.
That was sorry ass.
You want to see two more? It's our Thursday night football game.
Oh my god, who the hell cares?
Thursday night football.
Chargers versus Raiders.
Is this going to be who gets stabbed worse in the stands game? Yeah, who gets stabbed more times in the stands, Raiders or Chargers fans? I'm just telling you right now, I will have at least two or three fight videos up at sportscastlife.com after this game.
Yep.
I'm going Raiders at home, though. I'm going Raiders. I'm going to go Raiders at home.
You know what's ironic?
Black hole.
This could have been the last game the Chargers play at home, right? Every game, there's more fans from the other team.
Yeah, Raiders
than the
could
Chargers.
Travel.
Maybe if you'd have shown up and sold the place out, they wouldn't be leaving your sorry ass city.
So you can go Raiders?
You know? Just stay calm, San Diego. Or stay what? What is it?
Stay classy, San Diego.
Stay classy, San Diego. That's what I'm talking about. Stay classy. When you go to Oakland, stay classy.
Okay.
Raiders.
Renee? Wow, that's it. Oh, man. Is that the Raiders fans?
No, yeah, they're shanking. They're shanking Chargers fans.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's the shank sound
that's
effect.
That's the shank sound effect right there.
All right, Corey, what do you got?
Being a Chargers fan.
I know you're a Chargers fan, man.
I hope they lose. I hope they lose. So
I know
Raiders.
You want the draft
and
pick,
and
right?
I have Amari Cooper on my fantasy team,
okay, so
Raiders.
I'm going Raiders in this one. All right. Next game. This game's got a lot of playoff
huge,
implications here. Here we go.
Huge implications.
Redskins versus Eagles.
Redskins, Eagles. I think whoever wins this game wins the division. Redskins versus Eagles here. Redskins on the road. Again, Kirk Cousins, the man, going off last week.
You like that?
I did like it, Kirk, and I liked it for a lot in the past 6 weeks here. And I'm going to go with you like that again. I'm going Redskins on the road. I need an upset. A lot of people are going to go Eagles here at home here to bounce back. I like Redskins on the road. Knocker, what you got?
Well, this is the game I need to make up. I need to make some ground up here.
Should we go racist work last week, right, Renee?
Yeah, it's been
racist work last week.
Both teams. I know, but the Redskins have won two in a row, which is, you know, fainting style. They've actually won a game on the road to win two games on the road in the same season. Nah.
Not going to happen again? You're going Eagles?
I'm going with
all right,
the
I'm going Redskins.
Like an eagle.
Renee, let's do it. Race, baby.
Eagles are going to lose this game.
All right. All right, Corey, you got to go Redskins or Eagles, man?
I'm going to be politically correct here and say I'm rooting for Washington.
All right, you're going to go Washington. All right. All right, next game gets me. It's also going to be a great game. Must win for
God,
one
we
team.
Have fun, don't we?
We do.
Holy crap.
We do have a good time. Big game here in the AFC.
Patriots versus Jets.
Patriots versus Jets. Jets looking on the outside, looking in right here after that Steelers win. Patriots on the road against the Jets here. Jets at home. Patriots on the road. If you're the Patriots here, Knocker, you've kind of maybe locked stuff up in the AFC. Do you sit players? We saw the Honey Badger injury.
Well, they lost Amendola.
They did. Patriots again on the road here against the Jets. Jets are going to come out, I think, one of their best games of the season. I'm going to go with Tom Brady and the Patriots to go on the road.
That's so awesome. Back that
ass up. No, I'm not. I'm going Patriots.
I'm going J-E-T-S, Jets.
I am going, hold on.
All right. Patriots, I like it, Renee. Corey, Jets or Patriots?
God, I hate the Patriots.
Everybody.
So I am going to be like your father, and I'm going to do a little. I hope Chris Ivory has a heck of a game.
So you're going all fantasy plays this week?
Yeah, I mean that's
basically what it's doing. So if you want to, so you can go sound effects with Renee. Yeah. You can go fantasy plays with Corey.
Right?
You can go making up ground with Bud Knocker and Josh.
Right?
So
or
whatever
you, can go
you
smart
want to play.
Pick with Josh.
Yeah.
Right?
Either way you want to go. You got four
you're
different plays
with me. Yeah. Sound effects.
Yeah.
Or
it's been working
fantasy
for me.
Or yeah.
I approach it as almost, you know, if I was in Vegas, I would totally put money on the Jets to beat the Patriots because they're not going to be
spread.
Favored, and you know,
I might take that spread though. You might get 7 points to the Jets in this game. I mean,
this probably looking. Any spread.
Okay, then.
Maybe like a garlic shmia?
Corey, you gonna... I'll give you a little... that's a good ding. I like that one. That was a good... All right.
You like that?
You like, yeah.
You like that?
You like that? You like that? You like that?
All right.
I love this show.
Knocker, next... So, we're all going Patriots, except for Knocker. You're going,
I'm going Jets.
And Corey.
All right, and Corey, you're going Jets. I'm sorry. Texans, here we go. Next game up here.
Texans versus Titans.
Texans, Titans here. Texans, man. Big win.
First ever
big
win in
win
Indy.
Against the Colts.
Yep. And they came back.
Shout
they
out to our cheerleaders,
early.
Man. Texas
Ashley
cheerleaders.
R, Madison, Sarah C.
All you girls. Big game.
Natsuki, all of them, man. Libby, Madison,
official cheerleaders
all
of the show. Love it. Texas cheerleaders. I'm rolling with you guys again. I don't care who your quarterback is because your goddamn defense is so good.
TJ.
It's ridiculous.
TJ went out.
I'm going Texans on the road versus the Titans here. Knocker, what do you got? You
well,
going Texans?
TJ Yates had him losing. Poor TJ got in the game, had him losing. So, you know, he got replaced by Mr. Hoyer. Brought him back.
All right.
I feel real sorry for Mrs. Yates because she was just going, oh, foosball. My TJ's in me playing foosball.
You know who knows how we're talking? Tyler right now, Mississippi.
Tyler knows that Mississippi right there.
Who you got there, Renee? Here we go.
Are big and bright. Deep in the heart of Texas.
Yeah, fuck you, Mr. Awesome, and your stupid fantasy rules. I'll talk about it later.
Biggest comeback ever coming
yeah,
up, Josh.
Seriously, yeah,
coming
really.
Up. You watch.
Did they pull Breeze already?
Quarterbacks. I'm going with the Texans.
All right, well, you got Texans? Yeah. Ray's going Texans. Corey?
J.J. Watt, baby. I mean, they're looking
we're
great.
We're sweeping the – I think it's the first week we sweep the Texans this year. Texans, baby. All right, next game up here.
Browns versus Chiefs.
Browns on the road with the Chiefs. If one, I think, 8 in a row right now, Knocker. Hottest team in football, Chiefs at home.
That's because of my sound effect.
Can we just sweep it now, guys?
Yeah, well, thank God, because I really felt like a fool after 3 weeks because I picked the Chiefs to win the division. I feel pretty good about it now.
Connie Menzel, you should stay in college, drinking with the hoes. Know where you from, Arrowhead, beat the Chiefs at home. Dude, oh my God. Good thing the FCC does not, like, control this show at all, because we'd be in so much goddamn trouble.
You guys are pretty racist,
Knocker,
man.
You on camera in a Kings and a Ball Humbug hat doing racist Indian chants is hilarious. All I have to say.
You don't get this anywhere else.
I am sending this to Keith at KLOS tomorrow.
You have to.
All right, next up, so we're going to sweep the Chiefs. Here we go.
Yes.
Colts versus Dolphins.
Colts versus Dolphins.
This isn't your blackout game of the week?
No, there's a worse. The next one.
There's a worse game than this one?
Yeah, next one.
No way.
I swear, yeah, next
No
game.
Way.
Yeah, next one. Colts versus Dolphins. We got a phone call, but let's go over this game real quick. Colts on the road versus Dolphins. I'm going to go Colts here on the road. Dolphins, I mean, they're just pathetic. I got to go. Colts haven't shown me much, but they got something at least to play for. I'm going to go Colts on the road. What do you got, Knocker?
Dude, it's such a shitty game.
I know, it's bad, dude.
Where's the I don't give a F drop?
I don't give a
that for me.
Oh my God, hell cares?
I don't give a fuck.
Yeah. So the I don't give a fuck game of the week is Colts Dolphins?
Absolutely.
You know, I need to put that on the board now. We need to have that with the blackout game.
I'm going with the home team.
You're going Dolphins? You just talk so much crap on the Dolphins.
I know, but still.
Oh, my God. Wait till you know. Back that ass up. All right. What do you got, Renee? All right. You got the Colts.
I mean, Hasselback's still playing, right, for the Colts?
I'm going to go
Miami because Ryan Tannehill is way better than.
All right. We got phone call still.
Yeah, sure he is.
What, Mr. Awesome? Oh, it's Mr.
Right?
Awesome. Oh, Mr. Awesome, how you doing, sir?
I'm doing all right. How are you?
You know what?
Well, tell him to suck my balls.
Your rules suck.
Yeah, your rules suck, you cheater.
Hey, you picked him.
You changed the rules.
Okay, you picked Breeze.
I'm gonna.
You
call,
picked Breeze.
You know what?
I gave you. The opportunity to pick
Mr. Awesome. The rules. You know what? I was gonna wait till shit of the week, but you're getting called out right now. Right now, Mr. Awesome called me up today. I play in his fantasy league for money. And normally in fantasy rules and in games, if there's
a tiebreaker
in the playoffs, it goes by most points.
Who acquired the most points
in the season,
over the
total,
season? Yes.
Which was me.
That's the first tiebreaker.
Which was me. And I'm playing Mr. Awesome right now to go to the finals. Me and him. I'm the one team and he's the four team.
Right.
And so that's not the tiebreaker in his league.
Oh, no, we're not going to do that, Josh.
No, because we tied.
Okay,
we tied
so
in the playoffs.
So the second tiebreaker
would be
the higher seed.
I didn't make that.
Hey, you be quiet, Josh.
You be quiet. Yeah,
mute him. Mute him.
Yeah, shut up right now.
You be quiet right now.
Shut up. We're talking.
The stars at night are big and bright. Keep in heart.
So that's not his rule, right?
Like, sit there and take it like a man.
Like most fantasy leagues, that's their rule, right, Knocker? Most points for?
That's what I heard.
Okay, but no, not in his. But in his league is, okay, whoever ties the top seed advances.
Right.
So who's the top seed?
That would be you.
Me. Right? But no, he calls me up and he says, hey, this is Mr. Awesome. Call me after work.
Mm-hmm.
So he calls me.
I'm the commissioner, so I'm going to make my rules.
I'm the commissioner, and I think that this rule's stupid, and we're going to change it next year. So this year, I think instead of a coin flip, because that might be fair as well, we'll take the Monday Night Football game, and I'll give you first pick.
Question.
Will you get Lions quarterback or Saints quarterback? Whoever scores the most fantasy points, that's who breaks the tiebreaker.
I have a question.
Are you kidding me?
Did he pull all the other owners in the league, or did he just
himself? He did Pete Rozelle.
No, I talked to Pepe Pant and Josh, because they're the only two people left in the playoffs.
Oh, he talked to me and someone else.
No, the whole league, bro. You don't talk to the guys in the playoffs. You talk to the losers.
Jeez. I can still do that.
You are one pathetic loser.
You deserve.
Two of them didn't even pay,
dude. You deserve.
They sucked out of the first 2 weeks.
You deserve the bruised foot and the little soft cast on your leg, bro. That was karma because of what you just did. Bro.
Thank you very much.
Have a nice day, douchebag.
Fine. Exactly. You can have the win. Fine. You can have the win.
Yes, I guilted him out of it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, Kevin. Stand your ground, bro.
You stand your ground. Just say, I'm the commissioner. I'll do what I want.
Up there, it's still on. I got it. It's in writing now, so he can't back up.
So. You got to come back strong, Kevin. Man, Texas is not proud of you right now. You got to come back strong. You know what, Josh? Too effing bad. Yeah. I'm the commissioner. Yeah. You want to be commissioner? Yeah. You be commissioner. Yeah. I got to put up with this crap all year long. I'm going to make the goddamn rules, and if you don't like it, don't join.
Exactly.
How's that, Kevin?
Hey,
Kevin?
I need him in the league. He brings credibility to the league.
But I don't want him to win.
That's fantastic.
That's
great. Hey, Kevin Wendy, I wish you a Merry Christmas, man. And
you too.
Happy New Year. We appreciate you calling in. Good to hear
from
you.
Them Chiefs?
I do hope you get better.
Hey,
man.
Yeah. You know, you just jinxed them, right? You realize y'all all picked them.
That's why
you're going to lose now.
He said he hasn't been calling in because he's like, I don't want to call in and jinx the Chiefs. I don't want to brag
about
it.
Yeah, you did.
Well,
you know
what? They're going to lose this weekend. No, I'm just joking. We picked them both. So, hey, Kevin, man, Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. Say hi to the family, and we'll talk to you real soon.
Thank you, guys.
All right, man. Love you,
my brother. Love you, man.
Love you, buddy.
All right, man.
All right, guys.
See
let's finish up with our pick-ems here. Let's get to. So we all picked.
I'm sure he's glad he called.
So you went with Dolphins.
Yep. Whipped his ass for 30 seconds. Right.
Yeah, that's what he gets, bitch. Knocker, you went Dolphins.
Yes, I did.
Okay, so and me and Renee went Colts. Here it goes. Here we go.
You better have the ticket. Cause it's the blackout game of the week.
I'm dying to hear what this is.
49ers versus Lions.
No one cares.
Worse
come on,
than
like,
the Colts? At least,
yeah, because the Colts have something to play for. Both these teams have nothing to play for. The Lions have nothing to play for.
Okay, all right.
And they either do the Niners, so I'm going to go Lions at home after watching this.
Freeze! Touchdown pass, baby! Karma right. And interrupting the passer.
All right. I'm back in it.
F you, Kevin.
Yeah, fuck you, Kevin. Play the Texas
song. F you, Kevin.
I got to stick with my boy on this one, Kevin.
Yeah. The stars at night.
Fuck you, Kevin!
Big and bright.
Deep in the heart of Texas.
If for the new listeners, he hates that song.
That's why we're doing it.
So can we sweep Lions?
Hey, but the Texans cheerleaders are going, yeah.
Because we got to hustle through this. Can we sweep Lions?
Yes.
Sweep Lions? All right, I like it. All right, next game up here.
Cowboys versus Bills. You better have the ticket. Because it's the blackout game of the week.
There's two of them this week. I don't play it very often, but Cowboys, Bills. I'm going to go Bills at home in this one because the Cowboys quarterback, I don't know who it is.
Let's go Buffalo.
Bill. Renee. All right, Bills. Just sweep the Bills.
Maybe that's why they lose because they sound like a fucking cow getting cornholed.
I'll work on it for next season.
That's a cow getting cornholed right there. Let me ask
and
you
people,
this.
People are chiming in. They said, what are you talking about, blackout game of the week for the 49ers? They're playing for the first round.
Okay, let me ask you this. Is Frank Ryan's job on the line? Could they fire him after one year if you're the Buffalo owner?
No,
he's made a shit show.
Yeah, but he's
of this
still not
going
to get fired.
Man. Really?
Yeah, because it hasn't won like two.
I'm sorry.
Three games.
I let him go.
Yeah, I don't
I'm
think
saying
so.
It right here. If it's me, I let his ass
I
go.
Think it's okay, so we're going to go ahead and we swept the Bills on that one over the Cowboys. Next game up here.
Bears versus Buccaneers.
Man, Bears, Bucks, and Pickums is a big game. Bears on the road getting blasted last week by the Vikings. Buccaneers coming up short against the Rams. I'm going to go with Jameis Winston. At home, I just think they have a little more to play for as far as just Jameis, you know, and the team a little younger, a little more straight than the Bears. They know it's over. I like Bucks at home here. Close game.
Yo, ho, ho.
All right. There we go. Corey, Bucks or Bears, man?
I need to make some bets this week. These are pretty obvious games. I'm going Bucks, too.
All right, going Bucks this one. All
that's
right.
When they get you.
Yeah, that's what
I know.
Yeah, I know.
I
right.
know.
All right. Well, I got this figured
out. I got a problem.
I got this figured out.
So we swept the last two. Now we're going to get into, I think, probably another sweep.
Panthers versus Falcons.
Panthers versus Falcons. Do they keep the unbeaten streak alive? Or anyone calling the upset? Falcons at home here. Anyone calling the upset over the Panthers?
I am.
You are going to call it?
Yep.
You're going to go out on a limb here? Go Falcons over
yes,
Panthers.
I am.
Call the upset.
Yes,
yeah.
I am.
No one called you a genius on the show.
Not ever.
Not ever. All right, Renee, what do you got? Hey, you got ready up hands.
Drunk old man. Impotent. Stupid.
What do you got, Corey?
Oh, yeah. No way, man. Panthers all day.
All right. I think it's also another sweep here. We've got a lot of blowouts here.
Steelers versus Ravens.
Steelers-Ravens. Steelers going to just blast the Ravens this week.
Bet the under.
All right. Knocker, you going to put Steelers, though?
Yeah. Is Big Ben just incredible?
Dude, yeah, he
playing
is.
Playing on one leg,
he's
bro.
top five quarterback for me ever. Top five quarterback. I love him. I love him.
Leg
I love
still
him.
Winning football games.
I agree.
And
Big
they
ben.
Have the... They have
the top receiving
have
core.
The best receiving core since the 90s
Cowboys.
Yeah.
80s 49ers.
Yep.
I mean, seriously.
Maybe since the Rams.
This, yeah, this is some greatest serious show on turf shit
right
there. On.
I mean, they're close to greatest show on turf yes. right now with Bruce.
Yeah, this yeah. is some serious. I mean, Akeem, Ben, yeah. Ben is not Kurt Warner because it's not the same style.
He's fantastic,
but for
though.
Three professional
in cold
wide
weather,
receivers,
what you need out of yeah. a playoff quarterback,
these
Big Ben's there.
These guys are amazing.
Black and yellow. Renee's going black and yellow. That's right. You're going to go sweep all it, day. Right? All day. All right, next game up here.
Jaguars versus Saints.
Jaguars and Jags Saints. Jags on the week. Road. Saints getting blown out they right now by me. The Lions.
Oh, no, they're coming back. And they're
going to
win.
Oh, we'll see, Knocker. All right, I'm going to go Saints. I'm going to go actually Jags at home here because I think they're going to sit.
No.
Game.
It says Jags.
I mean,
at
Jags
Saints.
On the road. I'm going to go Saints. I'm sorry. I'm going to go. I think the Saints are going to sit Drew Brees, and I'm going Jaguars on the road. Because Saints have nothing to play for. I think they're going to be like, you know what, Drew Brees, sit out. We don't need you in this game.
Saints, bro. There's no way they
I'm going Jags on the road.
Nope.
Corey?
I'm going Jags. Blake Bortles
looking
fantastic.
Yeah, Blake Bortles
looking
good. I like it, too.
What do
you got, Renee?
Saints. I don't have a sound effect for it. All right.
I just hope they wear those mustard uniforms. Those were so cool.
Those are so gross.
All right. Next game here.
Rams versus Seahawks.
Another blowout here. I mean, these games are. I mean, I think it's kind of easy pickems here. It's
we
hard
should
to
do
pick
a
upset.
14 game parlay. Vegas,
I know, really.
Man.
Should a Seahawks at home blowout knocker?
Oh, it's not going to be a blowout. No way it's going to be a blowout. But the Seahawks.
I'm calling big blowout here.
No way,
I'm calling at least by 20 points.
Okay,
Seahawks win.
We put a 50 on this.
Oh, give me two touchdowns. I'll give you two touchdowns.
We put a 50 right here.
Okay, right here. Right shake 50. All right. So Seahawks win by two touchdowns.
Yes.
Okay.
Ain't nobody talking about me.
That's right, bitch. That's what we'll be saying this weekend. What do you got, Corey?
What sound do you think a Seahawk makes? You
oh, we've
I mean?
Got like, it. Go ahead. What does a Seahawk make?
Ain't nobody talking about me.
That's what they make. That's right.
The Richard Sherman bird.
All right. Next game here.
Packers versus Cardinals.
Ooh, good game.
Good game. Great game.
Good game here.
Really?
A lot
great
of
game.
Yeah, a lot of the Cardinals-Packers, huge game
this
in the NFC.
This is a great game.
Huge game for both these teams. Cardinals look for home field advantage throughout the playoffs here. If they win this game in the NFC, besides the Panthers being on top of them, they'll be able to get there. I like the Cardinals. They come out big in this game against the Packers, especially at home. I know they're missing Honey Badger, but I think the Cardinals at home are a different team with Palmer. I'm going to go Cardinals here.
I totally agree. I'm not sold on the Packers.
Me
anymore.
Neither. I'm not.
I'm just
not.
Not against 80%
a formidable
of the
team. Right? Yeah.
Against 80% of the NFL, the Packers will win. Yes. Against the top cream of the crop, 8 teams in the NFL, yep. I don't think the Packers have enough going Arizona.
I'm going to go Arizona as well. What do you got, Renee? All right.
Wow, a lot of sweeps. I mean, how can you not go with Arizona? Yeah. That O-line is disgusting.
All right, here we go. Another big game in the NFC, Sunday Night Football.
Giants versus Vikings.
Vikings, huge win over the Bears last week. Giants lose another one in the last 30 seconds,
my
knocker.
My God, how
I mean,
many
there's
weeks
a reason
in a row.
Why Dan Burlington's not here and he's getting right. laid by his girl who's been in Europe for the last 3 weeks.
Right.
My
three
God.
Months.
Yeah, he's like, dude, I'm going to go crazy tonight. I'm not coming in. I'm going to go nuts.
I'm having sex tonight.
Yeah, I'm going to go Vikings. I'm actually going to go Giants on the road here. I think they get
what?
It done. My upset pick of the week. Giants.
Are you serious?
Yes, Giants on the road versus the Vikings. Nah, actually, I'm going Vikings. I really thought about it, and I was like, that's just really stupid.
That's so
if you're
going to
make like a bold call, don't be that
and
one.
The yeah. only player they have on offense is Beckham, and he's suspended.
Yeah, I'm going Vikings.
What the
I just
hell
thought
you
about that.
About?
Yeah, I don't. You know what? I had a couple too many of these before the show. What do you got, Knocker? What do you got?
I'm going Vikings.
Cool. Vikings?
Yeah.
Yep.
Vikings sweep. All right, here we go.
Monday Night Football.
Right in Corey's town.
Great
here.
Game.
Bengals.
This is a playoff game. I would love
Broncos.
To see this in
Bengals,
the first round.
Broncos, A.J. McCarron going to be playing in this one on the road. But both, I guess you could say
is
rookie
he
quarterbacks.
His wife?
I hope so because she's
God, baby. I hope so.
They just had a baby, actually. Congratulations.
Really?
Yeah, Bengals, Broncos. Wow. Broncos at home here. Need this win big time. Bengals also. I mean, both these teams need it for home field advantage. I think
yes,
whoever wins this game is going to get that exactly.
In the first round.
Mm-hmm. Broncos at home here. I like the defense to come up big against a rookie quarterback in A.J. McCarron here. Not much time under center. I like Broncos here and Brock to get it done in a very close, great game here on Monday Night Football. I think this is a slug match. I think it's like a 17-14 type of game. I don't think there's a lot of offense. I like Broncos at home here by a field goal.
I'm going Denver because I think they're going to create 3 turnovers. And they're gonna get one pick six fumble recovery special teams thing. I think that's going to happen. The Denver defense is quick. They're fast.
Mm-hmm. Couple turnovers.
AJ has not faced a team like this, although he's a serviceable quarterback.
Right.
I'm going 23-17.
Yeah, kind of that.
Denver.
Yeah, I agree with you. It's going to be cold. It's going to be a low scoring game. Oh, the Bengals. All right, for Renee. he's unique, folks. He really digs deep for these things.
Yeah. Very eclectic.
I know you like that.
I
know
love it.
You like that? You like that?
Yes, Renee, honey. I love that.
Oh,
that
my
was
God.
You're going Broncos at home, right?
You know, it's going to be that. This is the first game that we've talked about that's going to be exciting to watch.
Yeah.
Like, that's going to be a game that
it's
you can
be a
sit
great
down,
Monday Night Football game. Yeah.
You know, you tell the wife, honey.
Put the fire on. You know,
I took you out last week, bitch. Yeah, I'm watching football.
Alone.
Hey, yeah. Fucking. Right? Yeah, I miss the Saints and the fucking Lions, okay? We're going to watch Denver this week versus the Bengals.
I'm curious to see who's favored, though.
Weren't
like,
the
who's favored
on
the spread
like
for
that?
That?
And then after the game, after my team wins, you're going
to. Tell him to suck my balls.
That's right. Now, can we got your song of the week coming up right now? What do we got coming up at the break here?
Oh, we have got the second best rock and roll band in the history of rock and roll, and I am just talking rock. We are talking Black Sabbath, one of the greatest albums, top 10 albums of all time. It's
nice.
The title song of the album. We are going to listen to a little Paranoid.
All right, we got that
Black
coming up right now.
Sabbath.
Knocker's Song of the Week. Also, guys, get your Shot of the Week awards. We got a bunch coming in on Twitter at sportscast_THN. Call the show at 818-435-8423. Christmas time coming up after this.
Christmas
we got presents.
Time.
We got your favorite Christmas movies and what they say about you. And what's that really, that sweater? Those pair of socks? That jock strap you got for Christmas? What's the worst Christmas present you've ever got? That. And a lot more coming up right after this.
Got me.
2015. You guys have been fantastic. We'll get to our finals New Year's show next week. We'll probably do it on Monday, I believe, for the New Year's knocker. Sound good? We'll do another Monday show next week. Actually, we might do it Tuesday because I don't want to get involved in that Monday night
game. No.
Yeah, hey. We'll probably do it Tuesday next week before the
All I know is.
All I just want to say our hockey teammate, Sean, a.k.a. What's his? Orenthal J. Simpson. Yeah. He loves your air guitar skills.
Nice.
He just texted me. Yeah, nice. Of course he is. Of course.
I've rocked it, man. All right. Nothing says Christmas like Ozzy Osbourne, Black Sabbath, and Paranoid.
All right.
Yuletide.
Merry fucking Christmas.
That's right. This is on Paranoid.
Yeah, it says here from at Sturm375 says, Knocker putting on a show. Rock on, Knocker.
Yeah, baby.
Everyone's loving Knocker's air guitar. Right?
Knocker got laid last night or something.
2 days ago.
God damn.
But it lasted. At my age, it lasts a long time.
All right, now let's get to shot.
No, whoa, whoa. What with this? Yes. That Irish. Can we show this thing? If
well,
you can't
it's
see this.
Hard to, we tweeted out. We'll
okay, but Irish
it.
Chimes
it's retweeted.
In with,
it's retweeted. So
I
it's
love this drunk
there.
Irish. Kicked the wife out of the room while she left. Can't teach ignorant.
Wow, that's to his
that's
wife.
That's us.
That's to his wife.
That's a T-shirt. Wow. Can't teach ignorant. Yeah, sportscast.
Sportscast.
She's a bitch.
She's a bitch.
Oh shit, dude! So many wives just got pissed at their
husband. Oh my god!
Whoever just listened, we just
She's
about.
A bitch.
Wow. Like I thought this was the Christmas show.
Neither one of you talk like that to your wives at all.
Oh,
both
god,
of you are
no.
so
no,
hand-packed.
I didn't say that.
It is insane.
Irish said it. We didn't say
Irish
anything.
Irish is so fucked up. He's going shot. Wait. Oh, who the hell cares?
Yeah, he is. Yeah, he's jacked up. All right, we got shot of the week brought to you by Fireman's Brew, official beer sponsor of the show. Check them out at firemansbrew.com, guys. The Menage a Trois beers, the brunettes, the blondes, and the redheads. You know we love them. If they're not in a location near you, check them out at firemansbrew.com. Again, a portion of the proceeds when you guys buy their beer go to fallen firefighters' families and a bunch
Absolutely.
Of other great causes. So check them out today, firemansbrew.com.
Your money goes to a great,
they are fantastic.
Great,
so,
great cause.
Knocker, I'll get to you first. What do you got for your shot and your shits this week?
Oh, my God.
Are you not ready to go? You want to go to Renee?
Yes.
Okay, Renee, what do you got?
My shot of the week, we drove up to Carpinteria this week and got to hold my niece for the first time
nice.
On Friday night. So that was awesome. She's a sweet little baby. And
fantastic.
She gets my shot of the week. New member of the family.
All right, I like it. That's fantastic.
Everything healthy? Everything's good?
Yeah. 8 pounds even, dude.
They're 8 pounds even, just like I like it. All right, there we go.
Picture of her on my Instagram.
Yeah, go check out. What's your Instagram?
Spacey Basie. At Spacey Basie.
Okay, I'm ready.
It says a lot about who he is. All right, what do you got?
This
Doctor?
Could take a minute because I'm Santa, so I'm very, very giving today.
Oh my God, who the hell cares?
We'll try and make this quick. First of all, LeBron James for taking time out in a basketball game against the Celtics.
I did it last week, but it's cool. But
you did that last week.
Okay, well, then never mind that, but you know, I thought that was really cool. Shows how
I'm fit. Just a sweet transvestite.
Yeah! We forget things. Like our gender, who we like, our sexuality. Yeah. We forget shit.
You guys
okay?
are ridiculous.
Kelly Slater, and you put this on the website.
It is.
For spending, I don't know how much money, but 10 years in creating the absolute perfect man-made wave. If you have not seen this, go to sportscastlife.com and check this out. This is not your, you know, tidal wave or, you know, whatever the water park is in your town.
No, it's not like at Raging Waters or
right?
the wave pool.
Right. This is a legitimate, perfect man-made wave, and this guy could charge $500 a day, and there would be a line a mile long to go ride this wave. So here's to you, Kelly Slater. Also, the Houston Texans and our cheerleaders, babes on parade. The Houston Texans beat the Indianapolis Colts for the first time in their history. That's a good thing.
That's
a good
thing.
Week, right?
That's a good week.
Okay. Scott Cushman. Who is Scott Cushman, may you say? Scott Cushman was born with Down syndrome.
Okay.
He is the manager of Laverne Bonita High School.
That's the
basketball
city that
team.
I live in.
Yes. He
That's
is
the high school that we went to, right? Bonita High
right.
School?
Yeah. He is the manager of the Bonita High School awesome. Basketball team. It's a great basketball team. He started in a game last week. Scored the first basket of the game.
Nice.
Very, very, very
awesome.
Effing cool.
That's
very
fantastic. Cool. That is a good shot.
And
I
to
like
Robin Vanderkamp.
What, the Brady lover?
Yeah. Yeah, she sent us a thing, and I sent her a picture out to fight pediatric cancer.
Go check out loveyourmelon.com. They're doing great things for pediatric cancer. And, you know, Robin is way into this, and she's trying to get everybody
involved.
Only
thing that she's supporting, I'll support with her. So that's
great. Right. And, you know, the montage of that. And my shit of the week goes to Miss Columbia.
Wait, we have to play for this for shit of the week.
Merry Christmas! Shitter was full!
To Miss Columbia.
Oh, okay. You took one of mine.
No, we'll no. Yours is for something else.
Well, mine's for Steve Harvey.
Right, but mine's for Miss Columbia. Bitch, you lost. They made a mistake. You lost. You weren't robbed.
Yeah.
They didn't steal it from you. He read the card wrong. Shut the hell up. Yeah. Give the crown up, bitch. You lost.
She's a bitch.
She's a bitch. Taking that crown right off her head. Well, speaking of what Knocker's talking about, my shit of the week goes to Steve Harvey, man. Probably one of the biggest screw-ups you'll ever have.
You
had one job. It's to read the winner of Miss Universe contest, and you couldn't get that right. If you guys missed it, which I'm sure most of you did, because Miss Universe probably would not have as much publicity if it weren't for this mess up.
Right.
That
nobody,
Steve Harvey
I didn't even
had.
Know what was going
so
on.
So a lot of people are saying this might be a PR stunt. I don't think so. I think it was a really big mess up. But Harvey last night during the Miss Universe pageant named Miss Columbia as the winner when the card clearly read.
First runner up.
She was first runner up, and Miss Philippines was actually the winner. Now, you could check out the card on our website. Someone actually sent us the tweet with the actual picture of the card.
The actual
they sent
card.
It to me, like,
I
hey,
love
Sportscast,
it.
Check this out. And the card, it's like
clearly
states on the right side of the card in big bold letters who the winner is. It's Miss Philippines. It says on the left in little tiny letters, Miss Columbia's first runner up. And this is what it sounded like on live TV. Just imagine.
You're that woman, Knocker.
You've waited your whole
life. I've practiced not knowing anything about anything and just practicing on my boobs looking great and my face looking fantastic my whole life.
And I've worked all life for this. And this is what it comes down to.
Do I get to do my show?
One of you.
Yeah,
you
eventually. Shut up.
Is about
hey!
To become
I like titles.
New Miss Universe. If for any reason she is unable to fulfill her duties, the first runner up will take her place. Good luck to both of you. Miss Universe 2015 is...
The suspense.
I know.
Columbia!
Columbia, oh my God! Right? She's like, oh my God! Oh my God!
We have the picture of Miss Columbia. Oh my God! Okay, so now this goes on for about a minute and a half for celebrating that she's
they even put the crown on her
and the throne and the sash and everything. Now,
yes,
this is about. I'm gonna fast forward a minute later.
Yeah,
check that. Check that. Check.
Okay, folks.
Due to my public school education,
I have to apologize. The first runner-up is Columbia.
The Philippines girl's like, what?
What the hell just happened? And I love Miss USA right next to her, yes, egging her on. You won!
You won,
you won,
bitch!
You won! Go tackle the bitch! Go take her out!
I wish there was, like, all of a sudden, like, you just see, like, the Filipino people in the crowd, like, pull out guns. Like, yeah!
My shit.
2015 is Philippines!
It's Philippines! It's Philippines!
Is the Philippines, not
the Philippines. Public school education.
Play the video of her taking the crown off of her head right
here. Isn't that the best thing ever?
Check the video. You can check it on our site also right now as we show the vision. The girl's face like, oh my God!
Bitch, nuh-uh!
Dude, nuh-uh!
You did not just take that off my head.
Nuh-uh!
Oh, no, you didn't.
Oh, no, you didn't. That's some cartel war coming down on your ass.
Don't worry. Harvey apologized on Twitter, said, I'd like to apologize wholeheartedly to Miss Columbia and Miss Philippines for my huge mistake.
You
I
think?
Feel terrible. Secondly, I'd like to apologize to the viewers and all that I disappointed as well. Again, an honest mistake. And secondly, I'd like to apologize to the viewers and that all that I disappointed. Again, it was an honest mistake. Well, sorry, Steve Harvey. No one's going to remember your Family Feud days. They're just going to remember...
I think he deserves a Jimmy Kimmel.
I think he does. I suck my balls, Jimmy
Kimmel. How would you like to suck my balls?
I was quicker.
Tell him to suck my balls.
I was quicker than Josh. I had to get it.
Hey, you did. That was really... You were on top of that. So, Steve Harvey, you get my shit of the week.
No shit,
oh my
bro.
God.
You had one job.
One job. That's all you had to do. Lastly here for my shit of the week, also going to go out to... Kevin and your bullshit fantasy rules.
Rules.
Yeah, you fuck
the
you.
The sliding rules,
yeah,
the
your
floating
sliding,
rules.
Floating fantasy rules. Screw you, and I hope your Chiefs lose this weekend. Giants fans brawled in the bathroom over the weekend and they pissed in the corner. Check out the videos at sportscastlife.com.
Mr. Scrooge this show.
And also Snoop Dogg going off on Chip Kelly saying, kill yourself, you dumbass coach. He actually pulled the Instagram down.
Are you serious?
Yeah, so bad.
He's telling you to kill yourself. I hope you die.
Yeah, pretty bad. And I'll give my God. One shot. Goes up for the Panthers, man. I don't care if you guys almost blew that. For you guys be that resilient for Cam to come out after he got that first down, didn't celebrate on that last drive, mm-hmm. knew he
all
had to keep going all business.
All
Cam Newton and the Panthers, man, you get your shot of the week, undefeated. There you go. So Corey, what do you got, man? Shot of the week and shit of the week.
All right, shot of the week. I got two real fast. Shot would be get to hang out with you guys again.
Nice.
Because I go good. Back home.
Hey, okay.
I go
Colorado
back to Colorado
on
Friday.
Yeah, on Friday. Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
On Christmas Day?
Jewish.
Oh, you're Jewish. That's right. You don't give a shit about
great,
Christmas.
Yeah. Great yeah. price yeah, flights, bro.
Yeah, him and Christmas, he's
that's,
like...
You know what? That's the least traveled day
oh my God.
In the world,
who
right?
the hell
fucking, you're going to get an aisle seat wherever the fuck you want. You're going to be the only guy on the plane.
Yeah. Round trip flight leaving on Christmas Day through Southwest cost me
it's
158
all Jews, right? So basically, it's like all Jews at the airport on
yeah,
Christmas Day.
Right?
Like,
fucking eat Chinese
all Jewish
food.
All Jews
together.
All the time.
Oh, yeah.
That's good.
My other shot would be, Josh, you know how hard it is to win video game hockey all yeah. the time, constantly. Me and my buddy, we jammed out the last 2 days, and we are ranked currently number 46 in the world for the month.
Wow.
In NHL 16. We
wow.
won 20 games and lost three. I mean, we're just dominating the internet world right now with hockey. Your other son
so
would
proud.
Appreciate it.
I'm so proud.
I know.
You are one pathetic loser.
Correct, correct.
How old are you?
You want to ever tell you look like a penis with a little hat on
your head? Hey, at this age, you enjoy the small things in life. My shit of the week, though. Yeah. I would have to say go,
so
would
cool.
go to my Chargers. I didn't want him to win.
Yeah, you want draft picks, man.
I wanted draft
I
picks,
I was
God
happy
dang
the Cowboys
it.
Lost this weekend. So, all right, we've got
oh,
some,
my God.
We've got some shots and
well,
shits
on
Twitter, so get Dr. to
those. Dr. Rob comes in, and yeah. this is just great. Steve Harvey misspelled Philippines.
Yeah, he spelled Philippines.
And Colombia.
Yeah, Colombia.
In his apologetic tweet.
Yeah. Correct.
Are you... effing serious, no. bro.
That's true.
Are you serious?
Yeah, that's from Proto. That's from Proties right there.
The hood.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's also from Dr. Rob. That's awesome. He also says Merry Christmas. And I also want to get to a shit of the week from Douglas Logs into my Bears for not only losing, but not being in a position to get a number one draft pick, just
right?
like Corey. Do you have Star Wars music, man? I want to give a shout out for Star Wars. I saw it this weekend. Renee, it was fantastic. Also, Doug once chimes in. Love it for Star Wars. It was serious. I literally almost cried in
really?
Star Wars. It was fantastic. I won't give out any spoilers for those who haven't seen it, but awesome, awesome movie. It was a J.J. Abrams that
yes.
did it?
Mm-hmm.
He did a fantastic job. None of that CGI crap like in the first three.
Cool.
It was awesome. Love Star Wars, so big shout out for
Star Wars. I got to tell you, man.
Hang on. I'm going through shots here. Iris for being drunk here for shot of the week. Knocker, you get a shot for rocking at the break here.
Nice. Thank you.
Also, let's see. Hang on. I got a couple more here. Swim down. Bob wants to give a shot of the week for a samurai sword. I don't know what
that
means.
Oh, no. That's for the bat on the field. What are they going to bring next? A
oh, samurai
sword?
Swords?
Right.
Okay. And everyone that's sending me the Steve Harvey Dallas Cowboys are in the playoff picks, I don't like them, Colonel. All right, Knocker. Before he plays the music, what do you got here? Because we're going to play the music here.
What do you mean?
Are we going to go shots?
You just read them all.
Okay, good to go. Here we
so
go.
We're good to go.
Everybody!
Everybody!
All right.
Nothing better than a Stoli shot,
hey,
baby.
Let's get this show rocking. Let's do a little.
Let's do it.
Hey, let's do a little. How about this? Let's do a little college football.
Okay.
Let's go over some spreads here because you know I like to spread the legs. Let's spread it open a little
spread
bit.
Spread something. Yeah.
Ladies, yeah. If you're on the couch, especially Iris's wife, if you're listening, spread those legs for Iris right now. He's a happy man. We're going to get you some college spreads here, okay? Go over that after the break. Got some presents, Christmas stuff coming up. So it's going to be a lot.
College football, time for
last
me to eat.
Last good 45 minutes here of this show. Oh, my God.
Wow, bro. Really?
As Renee gets down to the last half of his sandwich from Wendy. Wendy made you a good sandwich, huh? Do you want to
no,
get...
she went in and bought them.
Who cares? Those are good.
You're supposed really, to give really Wendy credit for the sandwiches.
Oh, God, no. Wendy doesn't cook. I cook.
Oh, right.
I'm
by
Pinterest
the way,
whore, remember?
Yo, that's yeah. True. So we're going to create you your Bud Crocker account. We're going to create you an Instagram account so when you cook your beautiful meals, you can take a picture of them.
Yeah, people have already chimed in. They want to know if Bud Crocker is going to come back in 2016.
Absolutely.
Should we do a Bud Crocker cookbook?
Bud Crocker is going to have an Instagram account.
Yeah.
But I'm plagiarizing all this shit because I'm going to Pinterest to get them.
No one knows
that. I'm just
going
to say them out front, but at least I'm willing to do it.
Yeah, own up.
You always make
what I love.
You love to make a quick buck.
Last week, you had the Mormon War.
The Mormon?
Oh, sorry, the Mormon War.
Marmoon.
Yeah, they're not that jacked up on caffeine, okay?
You had Utah and BYU.
Yes.
Interstate rivalry. They absolutely hate each other as only Mormons can hate, right? My white shirt's cleaner than yours. No, my black tie is better than yours. My shoes are shinier than yours. My bike's faster than yours.
Mine's a Schwinn.
Yours is a crappy mountain bike.
You know, if you take the second M out of Mormon, it's moron.
Right?
Hey,
please download the show, Mormon. Spread the word to BYU.
All right. Well, we just lost all the Utah fans. But Utah, okay. What I loved was the lineman for Utah. I don't remember his name because it was a Samoan name, and then a lot of Samoans go to those Utah schools. He just stood up and said, you know what? I'm tired of this crap. BYU, you're a dirty team, and if you bring any of that shit, it's on. I love it.
Like it.
I just love it. Like you just it. After a week of having to interact with the other teams, Utah won that game 35-28. Okay, we got a lot of games coming
yeah,
up.
So give me the spreads. What do we got?
December 26th.
Give me the good games.
Well, okay.
Come on. Just give me the good ones that matter. People are going to watch.
UCLA is minus
on.
Six over Nebraska. UCLA is going to win that game and cover
so
that
take
spread.
Take UCLA minus the 6 points.
Yes, that's
okay?
December 26th.
That's Knockers play.
Tuesday the 29th. Number 10, UNC, who gave Clemson all they wanted
they
in
did?
That championship game. They're taking on number 17, Baylor, in the Citrus Bowl. There's no spread right now. It's really odd. There's no spread in
that
game. Is
the quarterback situation with Baylor? Or?
Yeah. I mean, I don't think they really know who the hell's going to play.
If you're going to take a side, who you like, though?
I like UNC because I think the game means a whole lot more to UNC
all right,
than
so
it does
no really,
to Baylor.
No play on that, but you like UCLA
right.
So far.
LSU minus 7, Texas Tech in the Arizona Bowl. I don't think neither team cares to be there. I am going to go with Texas Tech. I'm going to go with Texas Tech
plus
to cover
the 7.
Because I just don't think LSU gives a crap. I really don't.
So plus 7, you're going to take
gonna,
Texas
I'm going to take
Tech.
The 7 points in Texas
Tech.
Is
that the Red Raiders?
Yes.
All right.
Yes,
who you got next?
We have on the 30th, USC against Wisconsin in the Holiday Bowl
such
down in San
game.
Diego. I love
Does
Big
USC
10.
Does USC care about this?
Absolutely.
I think they do because I think their coach and I think recruiting has a whole hell of a lot to do with the statement that they're going
to
make
but
for the next
3 years.
But does
it matter more to the coaches or does it matter more to the players? Because the
no,
players
I think
are playing.
That, well, you have to understand, the players are coming off the suspension. I mean, the scholarship,
right.
You know, and the penalties by the NCAA, the bowl ineligibility, all this. I think this is a stepping stone for Clay Helton. And for the underclassmen at USC to say, hey, we're here, we're going to be here, and Alabama, we're going to show you what's coming next year in the opening game. I really do. If they come out and play flat, I'm going to be really disappointed. USC is minus 3.5. I think they covered this game.
They're going to take USC and the Trojans.
I am, because they're athletes.
And Bruins to cover.
Their athletes are better than Wisconsin's athletes.
Okay.
I really think so. You have, in the Orange Bowl, in the semifinals, you have Oklahoma minus 3.5. I told you, you were surprised last week when I said Clemson gets 3.5 points. Oklahoma is minus 3.5 in this game.
Is Vegas messing with my head? Is Vegas trying to mess with my head in this game?
You know what?
Are they trying to con me into taking that Clemson right now?
I think they are.
Does Vegas know that Oklahoma has a better quarterback and a better defense?
No, I'm not sure they have a better quarterback. They have quarterback that's equal. No, Deshaun Watson was up for the Heisman for Clemson.
Okay,
I understand. The dude for Oklahoma, I forget his name. But both of these teams, what make this game interesting is both these teams have a history of falling flat on their freaking face in huge games, bowl games, postseason bowl games. I think Clemson is the real deal. I like Oklahoma. I think they're playing well. I just don't like that Big 12 going up against the other conferences where they play real football, not that fast-paced, you know, blah, blah, blah football. So I'm going to take Clemson to cover. I buy the half a point, and I take them to cover the three.
You know what? I'm going to jump on that with you. I'll go Clemson with you in the points.
Okay. In the other semifinals, you have Michigan State plus 9.5 against Alabama. I'm going to go Michigan State and cover the points. I think Alabama wins the game by four, five, 6 points.
I think they got
points.
A decent quarterback. I think it's close. I think it may be. I think the Alabama wins by a touchdown, but no more than that.
Yeah, I you know, they're going to win the game, but I think the spread gets covered by Michigan State. This game, I love this game. Notre Dame, number 8 Notre Dame in the Fiesta Bowl against Ohio State.
Is this your lock of the week, college?
Notre Dame plus 6.5 against Ohio State. I'm going with the Irish.
Oh, really?
I'm going. I don't think Ohio State gives a shit about this game.
I agree with you, too.
Ezekiel Elliott's already
gone. They think they should be in the college football playoffs right now.
Half their team is checked out in these postseason bowl games.
I couldn't agree with you
who
more.
Who wants to be there more? I think Notre Dame is trying to build a program.
6.5?
9.5.
Oh, get by.
No, I'm sorry. 6.5.
Yeah, give it me at 7. Give me a touchdown in the
Irish. I buy that half a point. Give me that half a point in the Irish. In the Rose Bowl, you have Iowa plus 7 against Stanford. Stanford's going to beat their ass like a drum. On January 2nd, you have Oregon, TCU, and a pick'em. I go with Oregon in this one.
All right, let's get to a break here, guys. When we get back after the breaks, a lot of Christmas stuff coming up here. As we know, Christmas on Friday. Real quick on Twitter, Dr. Rob says, dude, you cried during Star Wars, The Force Awakens. I don't think I can listen anymore. Hashtag get a pair. All right, Dr. Rob.
Wow!
Star Wars down on me. It's Christmas season, you bastard!
Oh, he also chimes in. North Dakota State University going for their 5th straight FCS national title. The Bison are a badass team, man.
All right.
Check the Bison
out. All right, Dr. Rob, I like that. I didn't like your pun before, but I'll take that one. All right, guys, we get back. Christmas stuff. Give us your top 3 Christmas movies you like to watch during the season. Also, the worst Christmas gift you've ever gotten. We want to hear it. 818-435-8423 or tweet the show at sportscast_THN. Last half hour coming up.
Stay with us.
Christmas vacation. Christmas.
Christmas. We'll be back on Tuesday next week. Tuesday, do our New Year's show. Last show of 2015. Tuesday at 6:30 next week. Make sure you guys check us on iTunes again. Spread the word. Download us. We're all you guys can find. Podcast One, iHeartRadio, all that good stuff. Right now, we're going to get into our Christmas time here. As we know, Christmas on Friday. Want to wish all of our fans, listeners, supporters out there a very Merry Christmas. You guys are fantastic. You make the show possible, so we really appreciate it. Right now,
really,
we do have the
absolute most loyal, best fans on the planet, man. We truly do. I love all of them, man. I really do, man. They make life worth living, man. It really is fun to have a family out there.
It is very nice. As Sportscast family, you guys are, we love all you. We really do. So right now, we got some Christmas presents to go around. Renee, our producer, again, he sticks with us every week. Goes through the madness.
I have the best seat in the house. I'm last week. I'm like, dude, I have the greatest seat in that. On this show.
Everything you hear is because it comes out of that man right there. Right? Somehow, some way, he does it. No matter how many of these he takes during the show, he somehow finds a way to keep this thing
I don't
ready.
Know how he does it, man.
So, Renee, I want you to open it. Those are for me and Knocker there, so I want you to go ahead. And you get to go first, man, because you're much appreciated.
That
on
is
the one
so sweet. Wow, first time the Mexicans go first.
Yeah, I know, right? It's the so Christmas privileged. Season.
Well, it's a room full of Mexicans, so what are we going to do?
So, Renee's opened up his crib. Again, you guys can watch this live right now on Ustream. We'll have the video up tomorrow on YouTube.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah, got Dodgers shirt coming out. Renee, if it doesn't fit, less than large, I didn't know, so let me know if it doesn't. I got the receipt.
Showing the camera.
There you go. Very
nice.
Very nice. Thank you guys very much.
Doyers.
You want me to open both of this?
Yeah, go ahead. Open both, and then we'll go to Knocker next. Renee.
Did you ever go like this?
Yes, Josh did.
I did all the time. All
Josh
the time.
Is brutal.
I didn't want this. I didn't ask for this. I thought this is my Mexican
nice.
Dodger gift to you.
Awesome. I like that.
It's a Dodgers water bottle, and only that.
Slash.
It's a spritzer, so it spritz you in the face.
When you have those seats in
hot,
the sun on that day
there
game.
There you go.
So you know you're
or
those,
the pavilion seats. There you go.
That's awesome. Thank you guys very much.
Yeah,
that's
so you're in the
sweet.
Dodgers, or you're sweating out there with Sherry. You could spray the tits down
I
a little,
like
you know.
Wet t-shirt.
You can motorboat those.
You could go Buffalo Bill fan on your girl. That's just like do anything, you know, snort it off her breath,
yeah,
you know,
whatever you gotta
go
do.
For the stink finger from behind.
And
I just like Bills fans, man.
Trigger to miss.
Right
pretty,
there,
yeah, right
I know you
all.
Can't miss.
Can't miss.
Can't
love
miss.
It.
Awesome.
Right there.
Thank you guys very
Merry
much.
Merry Christmas, man.
So
Merry
sweet.
Christmas. All right, Knocker, go ahead. You got you're up next here.
Two?
You got two? I'm gonna spoil everyone a little bit. You know, I'm gonna throw it around here. Knocker's open up his again. You guys, we'll have the show tomorrow for you guys on iTunes. We wish everyone a Merry Christmas as we go through opening up gifts here on the Sportscast. Knocker's got his ball humbag beanie on.
Oh,
right.
Wow.
That's
all
right.
What I'm talking about.
So you got your Trojans
USC
coffee mug.
Cup.
I like
slash
it.
Slash vodka. Straight up.
So you like that?
We're going vodka straight up
you
in
like
this
that?
One. We ain't even going to put mixer in this one, baby.
Oh, you going straight vodka to work Bucking in that,
a,
baby?
Bro. Yep.
All right. All right.
And by the way, John McKay was voted coach of the century in the Pac-12. There could be no other choice.
Okay.
Fight on.
Fight on. For
Fight on.
As you guys know, Knocker, huge USC fan. So Knocker's first gift was a USC coffee cup
awesome.
There. Last one. This is my old man gift to you. So when your ass hurts because you don't get the good chair, you know, so I got you a USC butt cushion for
that
Knocker.
Awesome,
you like
Josh.
That? A
Thank
USC
you
butt
very
cushion.
Much.
So I know you don't get the good chair.
I always get the worst chair in the house. Yeah,
yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, so I got you a USC butt cushion
Thank
for
you.
You
so much, man. I might put this in my car.
Yeah,
even.
You know, it'll help your ass wherever you go.
The only problem is... I got a gas problem. I don't want to fart in this. This is going to create a dilemma, a conundrum,
for all
if you will.
For all those times you back that ass up on this
right?
show,
I'm
going to
back it up on my
back, it up.
Back that ass up on that Trojans there.
Fight on, right? man. Thank you, Josh.
All
Thank
right. Well, I got this one here. This is from
That's
Wendy.
Really cool. That's awesome.
It's from Wendy
from
and
both of us.
From Wendy and you. Yeah. So she brought this in. She's like, you got ass in open that show. So I was like, okay, take it. Let's see what we got here. It's wiggling around. It's in a box. So let's see. Mom always does the gifts right? Like, takes 10 minutes to open the goddamn thing. What is this thing? A Yeti Coolster.
Yes.
Part of the Yeti Rambler series. The last sip is as cold as
that's
the first.
That's right, baby.
So what is this thing?
That's for the golf course. That's a
what
prime
is this
time
thing? Twist high, off.
Yeah, you pour your beer in there, bad boy. And it stays effing
cold.
Right? So when you're on the golf course and that beer's sitting in the holder,
yeah.
You pour it in there. It ain't going to get warm, baby.
This is fantastic.
Isn't that cool?
I like it a lot, Mom. Very good, Wendy and Dad. I really appreciate it. Good job. I like it. The Yeti Coolster.
Right? Isn't that cool? Because you know that happens, right? You pour that beer and it sits there because you're taking a couple of shots.
Yeah.
You come back and the bottom third is warm. Now that's not going to happen.
All right,
Is it my turn?
It's your turn.
So this bag has a rip in the bottom, so just kind of be careful. I'm going to slide it across the table.
I have one in my bottom.
only Renee gives us bags from 10 years
ago.
Right? I used this for the past 10 Christmases.
It's the only one I have, eh? And can I have it back when you're done?
So this
it's got scotch tape on the bottom.
I'm going to have Josh open this one.
Okay.
I'll take it. This is for all of us, but it's for the studio. It's for you guys. All
right.
Okay. The studio, this is what I contribute. after all of these years, or all of these years, after
sorry.
This last couple years,
yeah.
You guys have been really, really awesome. So this is for you guys.
All right. I love it.
Thank you so much, Renee.
Let's see. I'm going to open this sucker up here. Oh, it's heavy. It's heavy. It looking like liquor, which is always good. Oh, yeah.
Read it. What is
a big bottle of Casanare
tequila.
So that's
really, really good tequila, yeah.
It's 40% alcohol, 80% proof.
Nice. For shot of the week,
thank you so much.
This is fantastic. Great. I like this. We haven't had tequila. Have we had tequila for shot of the week?
Yeah, a couple times.
Yeah. We haven't had it in a long time.
Not on a consistent basis. Now we do.
This is good, though. This is like the stuff that I will take my pants off.
Stuff I can't afford.
Yeah. I like it, Renee. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Yeah.
I have one for Knocker,
you know,
too.
Can we try?
You know what?
Renee,
should
we try this before
absolutely.
We get
to
it? Yeah, let's do it.
Go. Okay, give him his, and then we'll try the... Okay,
all
Corey,
I'm
going to
say,
is
sure. If that bottle's empty on one of the near shows, Michelle and I had a really good time.
Wait, what?
You know how the song says tequila makes your clothes fall off? Okay, if that bottle's half empty next week... You know the Knocker knocked it out.
Chill out.
That's definitely going to help
me. Yeah, chill out, dickwad. That's my mom.
Condoms? I got a bag of condoms.
I like turtles.
I don't need them anymore, bro.
I like turtles, Knocker.
I don't need them anymore, man.
They're not condoms, Knocker.
Hey, Knocker.
Well, everybody hurts.
It's an empty bag.
Yeah.
Hey, it's the Mexican shopping bag. It's empty and little.
Oh, man.
What do you got there? What do you got there?
Yeah! That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, Viagra! Oh, my God. He gave you Viagra.
That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, my God.
Hey, there's a story. There's a story behind that Viagra, right?
You got Knocker Viagra? What the fuck?
He's going to use it on your mom, dude.
Hey, Wendy.
Good thing Wendy's not home tonight. She
Wendy.
Went to grandma's for a reason.
So there's a story behind that.
Wendy, you got to drive home,
and why
baby.
It's only a package is because I
can't. Yeah, why is it an open package?
I'm about to explain. So I came across this fishing vest, right?
I got half a blue pill.
Listen, my aunt was having a yard sale, and there was this fishing vest there. It had some tags on it. It was brand new. It wasn't even used. It used to be my uncle's.
Oh,
and
wow.
So I was like, can I take this fishing vest? She's like, sure. So I took the fishing vest. Sherry's going through the pockets. And she's like, oh, my God, Renee, come here. Come here. And I'm like, what? And
are
she
you
goes,
serious?
There was fucking Viagra in this pocket of this fishing vest. And I immediately fucking laughed for like 5 minutes. And I said, let me have it. I'm going to give it to Knocker for Christmas.
Make sure it's not expired.
Look closely. The fucking package is
already
open.
You had he gave you an open package of Viagra for Christmas.
I don't know how old they are, so you might want to
oh, my God, Knocker. Oh, my God. That might be the best Christmas present I've ever...
Does that fall under one of the worst presents you've ever gotten?
Knocker, and I'm going to play this.
Go Power Ranking.
Viagra!
Go Power Rankings! Go Power Rankings!
That's one of the
the first Renee, thing we ever did on the
so
show.
It's so funny, Renee's like, yeah, I'm bringing gifts. I'm bringing a half-open thing of Viagra and tequila. Let's get horny.
Gift of erection. You're welcome.
Oh, it's a gay party. Yay.
Hey, I said they could be helpful, you know.
Guilty.
I have Knocker's Christmas song for his transvestite. Let this play for a minute, marinate. It's a Christmas time.
We'll take our shots. Let's take our shots. There is yours, Renee.
Listen to the
Renee, sir. Here's your tequila. Here.
I'm wearing her clothes, her silk pantyhose.
Yeah.
Walking around in women's underwear. In the store.
Cheers.
There's a teddy with little straps like spaghetti. It holds me so tight, like handcuffs at night. Walking around in women's underwear.
In the office, there's a guy named Melvin. He pretends that I am Murphy Brown.
He'll say, are you ready? We'll say, whoa, man. Let's wait until the wife is out of town. Later on. And join the parade, walking around in women's underwear. Lacy things missing, didn't ask permission. Wearing her clothes, silk pantyhose, walking around in women's underwear.
Guys, fantastic. Comes
that
in on Twitter.
Perfect.
Comes in on Twitter. Josh gets tequila and Bud Knocker gets Viagra. What could possibly go wrong? Sportscast. Oh, that's fantastic. That was good stuff right there.
That was.
Good.
Oh, I do like that.
That was a great song. Who was that?
That tequila. Like yeah,
maybe you should have
song?
Gotten. Let's see. Maybe you should have gotten
Bob
Bud Knocker.
Rivers. Bob Rivers on YouTube. Just type it in on
Bob
YouTube.
Bob Rivers, okay. Go ahead,
maybe
Knocker.
You shouldn't got a Bud Knocker UCLA butt cushion so you can shit all over it.
Oh,
that wouldn't have been bad.
Oh, okay.
But you know what? For the rest of the game, it's a little uncomfortable.
Yeah, exactly.
I'll take this one.
So you'll take that one. All right, guys. That was
thank
fantastic.
You very much, Renee.
Yeah, no problem.
Yeah, Renee, that was fun. All right.
Thank well, you, guys.
Yeah, no, thank you. Speaking of Christmas, I got, you know, favorite Christmas movies.
Yes.
There's a lot going on yes. right now, and I think they say a lot about who you are.
I think they do.
And
I,
right
I,
now,
I think you're
I've,
absolutely
I've
right.
got a list of the top Christmas movies and what they say about you. So again, we've had
all
some
right.
tweets come in at sportscast_THN. Also on Facebook, we've had a couple. You guys can call the show 818-435-8423. What is your favorite Christmas movie? Because you know what? It says a lot about who you are.
It does.
Renee, throw me on some Christmas. Can you throw me on some Christmas here
yeah,
right
yeah.
in the background?
And I mean, nothing like says Christmas like AC/DC.
What?
Oh, yeah. You want some Christmas?
Jesus Christ. I don't want some AC/DC. Knocker, now give me your top three
oh,
Christmas
easy.
Movies, and I want to see from my list how it describes who you are. So who's your, what's your number three?
In order.
Okay, give me your top, from the bottom to the top.
In order. Okay, now remember, I'm 56 years old, so
okay.
the list has changed
okay, well, this list
over
is
the years.
Say a lot about
okay?
you.
Okay.
Oh, we're ranking. Okay.
Number three, Home Alone.
Home Alone. Home Alone.
Really?
All right, let's see.
Oh, apps. Are you kidding me?
Yes, it's fantastic. I agree with Knocker.
Home Alone.
Knocker.
My, okay, okay.
No, just, your turn comes later.
No, I'm just trying to say, to be fair to your fans, I'm Jewish, so I'm going to be, I'm just interested in what.
So really, who really fucking cares what you think about Christmas?
No. It's just, I watch
you. He's so hurt right
wow.
now.
Wow.
He's
Dad,
so hurt right
mind
now.
Mind you, okay, fans out there,
my
the
God.
Way. The
this
way
started he's... before the show. We were on before the
oh,
show.
Oh, yeah. We've been biting. But mind you, fans in the radio world, that's my other father yelling
yes.
at me over there. So
we got a phone call, though?
Yeah.
All right, who we got in line here at the Sportscast before we get to our list?
You
who
know
we got?
I love you, Corey, man. You know
I love
you
too,
brother.
Dad. I love you too.
Caller, who are you at?
Oh, this is Rob.
Rob, what's going
what's up,
on,
Rob?
Okay, so Die Hard. What does that say about me?
What Die Hard? It's not a Christmas movie.
It is. You know what? It is.
It's
set at Christmas time.
About?
He's absolutely right. It's set at Christmas time.
Well, it's not on my list.
What a badass. I love it. Okay, what's number two?
I always watch that movie on Christmas, so you can't spoil it. You can't say shit about it.
You're absolutely right.
It happens at Christmas.
He's absolutely right.
You know what? He's absolutely right. And I'm going to write into this list.
And
people.
I am very afraid.
Yes,
at this moment, I'm very afraid.
My God. We have Viagra and tequila could get out of hand.
What's number two?
Oh, then after that, Die Hard 2.
Oh,
that's our fans. I love it. There's Rob, so much depth and intellect with our fans. I love it.
Hey, Rob.
No, that was it. Merry Christmas to you guys.
Oh, dude, we love you, Rob.
Thank you, Rob.
Yeah,
that was awesome.
Dr. Rob,
and you know
man.
What? He's absolutely right. Yeah. Die Hard is
it
set
is.
At Christmas time.
Rob, I'm putting it on the list, man.
All right. Sounds good.
Rob,
see you next year.
Hey, Merry Christmas to you, too, man. We really appreciate your support, and you've been sticking us again. From day one, you've been with us, and
I think Rob,
we love you to death.
I think Rob
I'm sorry that our Kings got your coach fired in Pittsburgh, okay?
Oh!
Yes, thank you very much for that.
I think Rob needs to go visit ISIS with
yeah,
all
he,
that.
Yeah, he's going to bomb him out.
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Right?
That's what I'm talking about.
Hey, Rob, we love you, man. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year, bud.
One of the...
Same to you, guys. Enjoy it.
All right, my
we'll
brother.
See you next year.
Hey, man, New Mexico made a bowl game.
Yeah.
What the hell's going on with the Lobos? Break that team up.
Oh, my God.
What's
my
up?
God. Hey, we appreciate it there, Rob, man, calling
I
in
love
all the
that.
Way.
You know, that's one of the best top 10 lines in any movie. You know, it's like, I'll be back, whatever. Yippee-ki-yay,
hey, motherfucker.
That's one of the best lines ever uttered in a
hell
movie.
Hell yeah, use this to my wife before we get it on. All right, here we go. Favorite Christmas movies.
Woo!
I hope she's not listening. I really
I don't need that.
Dude, I'm telling you. I just opened the door in my like my boxer briefs. I'm like, yippee-ki-yay, come, motherfucker.
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
And she screams and hides under the covers, and then I try and tackle her. all right, knocker.
So it's just a butt cheek night?
Yeah, it's more a pillow night. It's more pillow. It's not even butt cheek. It's just... It's more.
You definitely said that on air, Dad.
I did.
It's more Cooper and Smokey night than it is anything. My dogs. It's more like, hey, dogs, what's going on? All right.
Okay. Yippee-ki-yay, canine fuckers. All right,
Knocker, what's your favorite Christmas movie? Give me your bottom. Give me from the top.
Well, I told you number three was Home Alone.
Okay, Home Alone. So this is what it says about you, according to my list.
And this is a tie.
Well, you had a nice childhood where you handed a cushy job out of college, but you frequently post angry Facebook statuses about poor customer service and depressing photos captioned, "This could only happen to me."
That's pretty true.
It might be right on you.
Yeah, that's pretty true.
It is true because you had a nice childhood.
Mm-hmm.
You had a cushy job out of college.
Got to the phone company.
You got to the phone company. You kind of worked your way. And you do post angry messages.
I do.
Rant a lot.
Yes. Bah humbug.
Okay, so what's your second movie?
It's a tie.
Okay.
I'm going to have to say it is a tie.
Okay.
Because Christmas does not start in my family until we watch Christmas Vacation.
Okay, let me see. Christmas Vacation. What this says about your personality.
Wait.
You're the life of the
party.
What's
that one ranked? He's ranking Christmas.
No, they're tied.
No,
I have a tie.
Him. He's just giving me his top three. So for your Christmas Vacation movie, what this says about you, you're the life of the party. You're very good looking and absolute genius.
Perfect.
I think that says it all. So the first two movies have really described who you are.
Yes.
Okay, next up.
Next, I go to my sentimental side because this is really one of the best movies ever created.
Okay.
It's a Wonderful Life. Sorry.
Okay, it says about you, you cry a lot. Like more than Claire Danes on Homeland. A lot.
Well,
that kind of... You are a crier.
Well,
you are a crier.
The older I get, the more sentimental I am. And yes, I'm not ashamed to say it.
Okay.
Yeah, I do cry
so
when I see...
So would you say that kind of described who
yes,
you are?
Yes, absolutely. I
okay,
think it's
Renee,
perfect.
Renee,
absolutely.
Give me your top three Christmas movies, starting from the bottom. Your number
Beautiful
three.
Beautiful, Dad.
Scrooged,
okay.
Good movie.
Okay.
I like it.
Well, what this says about you is you're one of those people who passes on the shoulder during traffic jams and cuts in the last second.
That's totally me. That's totally me.
I love it. Way to work, right?
Yeah, when I go on freeway
AKA
off-ramps,
asshole.
When I go on freeway off-ramps, I'll totally drive in the carpool
lane. I see.
There
it
is.
I don't fucking care.
Yeah.
Fuck it. Why am I even going to stop at the stoplight? That's so stupid.
All right. So that describes you. So we're hitting it on. We're doing good. All right.
Good.
What's your next movie?
My next one is Christmas Vacation. Like,
all right, okay. Again, you're again Christmas Vacation.
Life of the party,
you are the life of the party.
Okay. Yeah.
You are quite good looking.
Hey, the Frankenstein costume, awesome.
You are very good looking, and sometimes you're a genius. when you're not smoking pot.
If you're ever sober, you're a genius.
What's your first movie? What's your go-to?
Man, every single year. I will never buy this movie on DVD because I look forward to it coming on TV every single year and playing 24 hours. A Christmas Story.
A Christmas Story. It says you lived in one town. It says right here. You lived in town, in one town your entire life, right? Pretty much.
Pretty much.
Oh, it almost hits you right on the head. All right.
Sure
all right,
is.
Corey.
That's just a great movie.
Corey, give me your top three Christmas movies here, and we'll say what they say about you.
Oh, man. Well, I doubt you're going to have any of them on there for the most part.
A Jewish tradition.
A Jewish tradition to the Christmas
Hanukkah
movies.
Hanukkah 1, 2, 3. And
a Schindler's List. Right? Like, what's on
oh
there?
Oh, my
right?
God.
Right?
No.
Trundle.
No. I guarantee at least two of these you guys are going to appreciate.
Okay.
Oh, no, it's dreidel.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
Dreidel. What did you say, Dad?
Drundle.
What are we it's fucking dreidel, reading dreidel. A Harry Potter book over here?
Drundle. Okay, go ahead, man. I'm
all
sorry.
Right. No. I love this. Number three,
Point Break? How is
Christmas
that a Christmas movie?
Movie?
Traditional Jewish movie to what? Watch during
people,
Christmas
people
time.
People stealing money?
Keanu Reeves. I am an FBI agent.
And that
Gary
says
Busey,
Christmas?
It does. It does to me. Oh, it really does.
Okay. That's not on the list.
Wow, you
ahead.
Jews really do hate Jesus,
yeah,
don't
seriously.
You?
Seriously. What else is on the top three?
It wasn't
Jewish.
Enough to kill him? Now you got to go Point Break at Christmas?
Dude, the Jewish top three is really crazy. Point Break is on the Jewish
absolutely,
top three. Okay.
Absolutely. Okay. Hands down.
Give me the next two on the Jewish top three movies to watch during Christmas.
Mind you, half of us Jews direct these movies.
So, Point Break is on the Jews' top three movies to watch during Christmas. What else
for
is on
Jews?
There?
Absolutely.
Okay. All right.
Number two, because we're very if you're an American born Jew, you're gonna watch the movie Miracle. On Christmas.
Okay.
The hockey movie?
The why? Because you beat movie. The Russians?
Are you effing serious?
Yeah, absolutely.
So you have Miracle and Point Break on the Jewish Christmas list.
Yes.
Okay.
That is the best thing I've ever heard.
Yes.
What's the number one?
Ever.
I can't wait to hear this.
No. And number one is actually an homage to probably the most epic Christmas movie of all time. If you're a comedian fan, which is... Christmas Vacation.
Okay. So you all threw right. one in there. All right.
Wow, that was serious
shit. So the Jewish list entails Point Break, Christmas Vacation, and what was your number two?
Number two was
number
Miracle.
Two.
Oh, Miracle. I'm sorry.
A hockey movie.
He's got all genres, suspense, sports, and
hey,
comedy.
Hey,
so,
it's Christmas
I mean,
time.
Miracle on Ice Rink Street.
Let's watch Miracle, man. That nothing says the holidays like Miracle, bro.
My God. We appreciate the underdog. America's always been the underdog. You know, it's a good movie to
He's
remember.
Like, Miracle!
Fuck yeah! And then half of the time, I usually, you know, this is going to be the first Christmas I'll probably be spending with a nice young
Yeah, he
lady,
actually decorated
so.
My tree with my daughter last week. He's like, I thought this was going to be hard.
It was so easy.
You thought it was going to be, like, hard to decorate a tree.
It's gone. There's two great prophets in the history of the world. Jesus Christ and Herb Brooks.
He's a savior. Oh, that's so funny.
Fantastic.
Coming on Twitter from Rob. For a minute there, I was worried he was going to say Valkyrie was his third movie.
Oh, no. Yes.
Oh, Rob, you get the tweet of the night. That's fantastic. Valkyrie is his third favorite movie with Point Break and Miracle. So the Jewish trilogy is Valkyrie, Point Break, and Miracle. Pick it up today at your local Blockbuster.
Nothing says the holidays like that.
That's fantastic. All right, for
oh
those.
Oh my God, that was perfect.
For those out there playing along, I know we've got a couple out there. I want to thank.
I'm not a good Jew.
No, you're not. Oh, no, you're not. From Bridget K on Twitter, want to give her a shout out. Since I'm at work, my favorite wow. Christmas movie. My favorite.
No,
Christmas.
Really, we didn't kill him.
Yeah.
We just crucified him. Yeah. It's not the same.
I'm not a good Jew.
Is that me? because that kind of sounds like my sound for a second.
Wow. I want to get to Bridget, though. Bridget K here on Twitter, at BKJr66, says, since I'm at work, my favorite Christmas movie is Original Miracle on 31st. My worst present
I like that.
My worst present is corn cob holders. Those two little prickly things
that somebody gave you
corn on?
Somebody
That's
gave
horrible.
You.
Let it snow.
That's horrible.
Somebody gave you the two little prong things to put on a corn on the cob.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
Who
that's
did you
bad.
Piss off?
Well, since your movie's Miracle on 34th Street, Bridget, it says here, you played with dolls until you were well into your teen years.
I believe that. Hey, Natalie Wood was smoking hot
All right,
as an 8-year-old.
Last year, I'm going to just go down the list about what...
Is that weird?
Wait, you didn't say yours. You didn't say what yours were.
Well, mine's going to be Christmas. Christmas Vacation's my number one. Home Alone's my number two. And How the Grinch Stole Christmas is my number
Jim Carrey.
Three.
So what does that say about you?
The recent one that they just put out, yeah, with Jim Carrey.
So
yes.
What does that say about you?
Jim Carrey says right here, says, I hate to break this to you, but you may be suffering from mild psychosis, and it's time to see a doctor. Yes, that's me. Yes, that is completely,
so, yeah.
That is completely me.
Proto checked in with Christmas Story, Grinch with Jim Carrey.
Okay, that's when we just already read
Christmas
those.
Vacation. So Christmas Vacation is by far
by
the most
those,
popular movie.
Yeah.
And Mr. Awesome checked in with Christmas Story, Christmas Vacation, and Bad Santa.
Oh, I have Bad Santa on here. Bad Santa says,
wow.
You have several different family Christmas parties to attend, but will probably not show up to any of them.
Right? Fuck them all.
Right? And his worst gift was a barbecue grill brush from Home Shopping Network.
Oh, that's horrible.
Somebody gave him
a barbecue
brush.
Grill brush?
A brush from Home Shopping
Network. That's horrible.
That's
pretty
bad.
That's terrible. We'll get to the rest of the bad gifts here. Just real quick, for all you others that have their Christmas movies you guys love to watch, we covered a Christmas story.
God.
If you like Christmas Story, it says you lived in a town your entire life.
Right.
So again, It's a Wonderful Life for all you oldies out there. You cried a lot. Like more like Clara Danes in Homeland, a lot.
Right. Okay.
So Elf, if you like Elf, if that's your top, your
Elf
favorite
is a good movie.
Your favorite Beatle is Ringo.
I do enjoy that movie.
Right? Okay. All right.
You like that, Renee?
All right. You're a little off
Renee
the wall.
Renee just spit out some of his drink right now. If your favorite, like we said, Bridges is Miracle on 34th Street, you played with dolls until you were well into your teens. Again, you can check out our list at sportscastlife.com. Home Alone, if that's your favorite movie. You had a nice childhood where you handed a cushy job out of college, but you frequently post angry Facebook statuses about poor customer service and depressing photos captioned, "This could only happen to me." Knockers right up
right,
there.
Exactly.
So am I. Home Alone 2, Lost in New York. You're the guy above's younger brother. You only say the sequel was better to piss me off.
Right, exactly.
You're that guy, you
right,
know.
Right.
So Scrooge, as we talked about, you're one of those people who passes on the shoulder during traffic jams like Renee and cuss into last-second traffic.
Ebenezer.
A Christmas Carol comes up next. Your old phone works perfectly fine. Thank you very much. And you don't need any of that fancy schmancy technology talk, folks.
You know what? The original,
you're that old fuck. You're basically that old fart.
The
if you like that movie.
The original Christmas Carol made back in the 40s or the 50s is an awesome movie. And then Disney came
and
out.
And speaking of, what kind of phone do you have?
A flip. What's wrong with that?
You have the old phone just like it says.
I have a flip phone. What's the problem?
No one has flip phones anymore.
I thought it was on the cutting edge.
Old people do.
Oh, yeah, old people have flip phones.
Whatever.
He is so not and old.
You have the jitterbug. You have the jitterbug.
I do with the big-ass buttons. My my cell phone is this fucking big.
Yes, the jitterbug.
It's like a clipboard.
Yes, the
right?
jitterbug.
And then Disney made a Christmas Carol with Jim Carrey and various other voices.
Yeah.
And the animation is absolutely fantastic. It's a wonderful movie. But that's one of the best Christmas
okay, well,
stories
if you
ever
like
made.
Jingle All the Way, you love Arnold Schwarzenegger.
You
way
are
too much.
Arnold
yeah.
Schwarzenegger.
You are Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Nobody else gives
a fuck. Yeah, because nobody else gives a shit about Jingle All the Way in Turbo Man or whatever that movie was about. Now, actually, this movie, Renee actually saw this. I don't know anyone who watches Ernest movies, but Ernest Saves Christmas.
Yes!
Yeah, that was
Netflix. Totally.
If this is one of your favorite movies, this is what it says
no
about you.
Burn.
Larry the Cable Guy is a man you both admire and envy. You have bought a fart machine as a Christmas present and for more than half a want more than your family.
I have bought a whoopee cushion once, but I do not like, what was his name?
What, Cable Guy?
Cable Guy, yeah.
Yeah, you don't like him?
I don't like Cable Guy.
Cable don't like Cable Guy?
Nah, he's not very funny to me. There's other funnier comedians.
He's funny, but...
I was going to put Ernest Scared Stupid
Oh,
as,
were you
going to
put that up
for my
there?
Number
as
three.
Your Jewish...
That was the Halloween one.
Oh, so that's...
I know.
So is that
I know.
It?
But
I just
that's what
the...
just Jews watch on Christmas Day.
A there with Point Breaking.
There is no
burn, burn, burn. Right?
Yeah.
You need to be able to go with green chili salsa.
So wait, you guys actually watch these Ernest movies?
It's on Netflix right now.
Ernest is the best.
Oh my God! All right. Well, if you guys' favorite movie is
and
White.
It's not the Onion Whisperer and the Jack in the Box commercials at the route right now. Is that not Vern?
It is Vern.
Is that not him, Ernest?
It might be, but I think the actual actor's dead. Jimmy
Well,
Varney.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oh. I haven't seen it. I'm sorry. I haven't seen it. No.
I know that he's damn Jimmy Varney. Never mind.
All right.
Yes.
I'm just going to say
just
yes.
Run the board.
I'm just going
to
say
Knocker,
yes.
Jesus, if I tried to engage you in intelligent conversation. My mistake.
If your favorite movie's White Christmas, according to this list, you're just fucking old, man.
Why is it gotta be a
You're just fucking old, man. If you're
Why got to be White Christmas?
Also, I've seen probably all these movies, too. Prancer. Remember that movie Prancer with the girl and a reindeer?
Gay.
You just checked into your OK Cupid profile. Right? Still no matches. So if that's your favorite movie. Saving Christmas with Kirk Cameron. There's about 90% chance you're voting for Trump. Just putting it out there.
Hey,
just
but
put
seriously.
It out there, guys. If that's your favorite movie, Saving Christmas, I'm just putting it out there.
Do you guys watch like the Rudolph ones and stuff like that?
Yeah, of course. Always, the old Santa ones? Yeah, of course.
Do you? I mean, for me personally, when I glance across them, I'm like, this is old claymation. It looks terrible. Okay. I'm going to fall asleep.
Yeah, the old
Yeah, the old ones are good, though. Yeah, they're good. Sure. Those are classics. Yeah,
I want to be a dentist.
Yeah.
Yes.
The Nightmare, the Nightmare Before Christmas.
Okay, good.
Right? Got it?
Yeah, okay. I got it.
The Nightmare Before Christmas, also on the list here, says if that's your favorite movie, washing your hair is not nearly as much of a priority as uncovering all the government conspiracies that the sheeple don't want you to believe. Next movie
I
here.
I love it.
If your favorite Christmas movie during the holidays is Love Actually, you are a single 37-year-old woman with more
Living
than two
at
cats.
Home,
with
right?
more than two cats.
Living alone at home.
And if your favorite movie is The Polar Express, you don't exist. And finally, Christmas Vacation. Like most of us, you're the life of the party, very good looking, and absolute genius.
It is the absolute number one Christmas movie ever, 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 ever made.
Now, Knocker, before we get out of here, I got the worst Christmas gifts you can give.
Yes.
On the holiday.
I can't wait.
Okay, the worst. Now, I want you guys to chime in here. We already heard a couple. We had corn on the cob holders. We had, that's pretty bad.
The barbecue brush.
Yeah, the barbecue brush.
Are you effing serious?
We also had Jockstrap come in on Twitter as
a
well. Yeah.
Somebody got a Jockstrap for Christmas?
Yeah, it's down in the Twitter list, but someone put in Jockstrap. So I got the 15 top worst gifts you can give on Christmas. So don't be one of these people. Number 15, calendars.
That means you just
unless
don't give
it's
a shit.
The Houston Texans right. cheerleader calendar.
You just don't give a shit.
You don't give a calendar, right Renee? Right? If you got a calendar, I'm leaving a big old shit stain on
that
your
is so
welcome
sad.
Mat.
You're right.
You know what's
funny? All right.
You know what's funny?
No,
that,
I don't.
Is that I made a calendar for my dad for Christmas.
Well, that's
what?
Making. That's
no,
different.
No, hold on.
That's
hold on,
different.
Hold on.
Wait, were you five? Were you five? Or like, were you 25?
I put pictures of us throughout the years.
Right.
You know,
no, that's different. That doesn't
like,
count.
You know, we did all that. And
that's personal. That doesn't count.
All right.
That's like, you know, you go to CVS and you buy, Winter Stories.
Yeah.
And you pull that one out. Hey, I bought that for you,
kittens.
Man. Yeah, I love
here's
you.
Two kittens.
Right?
Okay. Yeah. Number one, that's
Kitty World.
That's an adorable gift. Josh, as a son, you should do that for your father.
What, calendars?
Yeah, make a
no.
calendar of you two hanging
yeah,
out
give
playing
you a
golf.
No. Yeah, you
no,
want a
no.
calendar of me and Speedos for 12 months doing different
no,
poses?
But he would love
no,
that.
But I would love a calendar of you and Penny and
Oh.
Okay, so maybe we can
boom.
Put so calendars depends then. So we'll put that in kind of the 50-50 column.
Anything that is personal and made
okay.
by you.
But a kitty but like a cat calendar, like a kitty cat calendar, don't do that, right?
Really?
Right. Yeah. Who's gonna get that?
Really?
Okay.
I mean, you know, you, Jackie.
Number 14
and Penny.
Though, worst Christmas yeah. present to get a Christmas tree ornament.
No, that's bullshit.
No, I don't want a goddamn ornament. Give me something I can use
no,
during the year.
No, that's
I can
wrong.
Only I can
no.
only use that one time a year. Would you agree, Renee?
No.
Would you be upset?
I would agree with that. I would. I'd be like,
seriously, I got you a $20
you.
Gift card to, you know,
okay.
Edward Cinema. Yeah.
Let me
you
put
got movie tickets. I got a fucking ornament.
Let me put the caveat.
Like, what is that?
Can I put the caveat on that?
Oh, well, you can put your old man bah humbug
no.
spin on it?
If you're single, then yes, it sucks. Okay? Once you have a family or your godson, like Aunt Mel did with Matt, she bought him an ornament from the time he was 1 year old. Till now, she still buys him an ornament every single year. So it depends on the context, right? If you're buying a family present, an ornament with your picture on it or
you know, whatever, nativity. That's cool. You know, I don't have a problem with that. But if you're single,
you know, you're gay.
If you're single, if you're single and you get an ornament, yeah, they didn't like you. They just said, I don't give a fuck. I'm serious.
Hold on. I got
it. I'm serious.
I disagree. Well, I mean, I have a goddaughter. I have
Penny.
You know,
I know you're gay.
Thank you.
No,
it took a while, but thank
good
you.
Good timing. Yeah,
good time. Yeah, way to be on it.
Yeah, right on
literally
it.
The only human being I buy a Christmas present for and like wrap and put effort and time and shop.
My
is,
daughter.
Is his daughter.
That's good.
That is it.
That's great.
And it's my Christmas tradition.
There
and
you go.
And well, she looks forward to it. Like, sure. She comes up, so it's my way of, like...
But if you gave her an ornament that was special
no,
between you and her...
No,
absolutely.
Right?
I totally
that
agree.
That was personal between you and her? That's not bad.
Okay, so you're okay with a calendar and an ornament?
No, the calendar sucks.
Okay, well...
No, the calendar if it's personal.
Okay, from
again,
Rob here on Twitter says, last year I received a baking calendar as a gift, and I liked it. Okay then, Rob. Like this baking calendar, I guess so.
And I'm the fact.
Yeah, exactly. Next up here, you're gay wad. Number 13.
Look at it. He says gifts. Old open Viagra.
Yeah, worst gift ever.
How do you get worse than that?
I doesn't. Novel. Hey.
Used Viagra. Yeah,
that's pretty epic.
Number 13 here, knocker, and the worst gift ever for Christmas. Novelty anything. Don't get me wrong. A rubber something stocking filler here or there is just fine, but what goes through the mind of someone whose sole gift of the season is something that might as well be a dog toy?
I agree.
What do you give me a novelty something?
Absolutely.
Like, I don't get it. Don't give me a rubber chicken
don't
or anything
like that.
Don't
buy me like nothing. Right, give me a card.
All right, last year, number 12 here on our 15 worst gifts of the Christmas season, games for the wrong game system or DVDs for a blue player that
you
I don't
have
even
have. A PlayStation and they
yeah.
give you a
thanks for the Blu-ray DVD. I don't have a fucking Blu-ray. I'm a single guy in college.
Right, my nephew gave me a Blu-ray 30 for 30.
Yeah.
I can't play it.
Yeah, thanks for this.
I got nothing yeah. to play Blu-ray.
Yeah, thanks for the Sega Dreamcast that's not even made anymore. I appreciate the Sega Dreamcast game, right? Like, that's like a bad gift, right? How about this one, knocker? Number 11 on the worst gifts to give you for Christmas.
I got you Mario Kart, bro.
Yeah, yeah. Mario Kart 64, back when Nintendo 64. Hey, I got it for
you,
dude.
I got
you
an Atari, dude.
Seriously.
Atari game. I found it on fucking eBay.
I got
Space Invaders, bro. Enjoy.
Yeah. Yeah. I got you Tetris on Game Boy, dude. What do you got?
I would love that.
Yeah. How about number 11, worst Christmas gift? A star named after you. Really? What this present lacks is any enjoyment, happiness, or gratitude on behalf
Are
of the recipient.
Are you serious?
It makes up of the opportunity to make fun of the moron who spent $20 on a certificate, which means absolutely nothing.
I always wondered about that. Who are the idiots that are actually buying into this? Oh, see that star right there? That's yours.
Yeah.
Really?
Knocker, do you want to go outside and see our star I bought you?
Yeah.
Every year for the last 10 years?
I will love you so much to buy me a star.
I got you this... red velvet case that shows you where it's located.
And it's certificated.
And it's certified. And like, look, there's a fucking stamp, babe.
That means it's real. It's yours.
Yeah. Number 10.
You own that.
Number 10, worst present you
oh
can get someone
God.
During Christmas. A picture frame. Because anyone could get you a picture frame. Really?
Yeah.
I okay. go to Bed Bath & Beyond. I mean, really, to get that is cheap.
I think that's kind of borderline. I
okay,
really
number
do.
Nine, clothing that doesn't fit.
Worst.
That's why gift cards were invented.
The worst.
Here, honey, here's a $100 gift card to Nordstrom's.
Knock
go buy
out.
Yourself. Go knock
yep.
it. Don't buy people clothing.
I agree.
It just doesn't happen.
But all right. Is the return receipt in the bag? Like, do you get the gift and there's the receipt there
that
so you
is
can
so
return
Jewish.
It?
That is so Jewish.
Because then
so
I'd be
Jewish.
Like, I don't fucking care. I'll go
I hate
back.
The gift, yeah. but if the receipt's in there, I love you.
Yeah, that's right up. That's right up there
I'm
with.
Not a good Jew.
Yeah, that's such a Jew,
dude. That's right up there with Point Break and Miracle, dude.
You guys are pretty racist.
I'm not a good Jew.
As long as I can return it, I don't care. Is the receipt in there? Because I can get 12% extra. Because I got a coupon.
Renee, play that.
I'm not a good Jew.
That's right. All right. Number eight here. Number eight, worst gift to give on Christmas, a pet bird, rodent, or reptile. Please, I've been a recipient of this. I have two fucking parakeets that I want to fucking murder at my house right now. What's worse than thrusting the responsibility of caring for another living creature at someone without warning?
I told you from day one, you're an idiot. Enough said.
choosing a gross kind of living creature? That's what?
I told you from day one, you're an idiot. I told you.
If anyone wants two birds, tweet me at sports.
Two birds, three dogs, or a fucking parakeet.
And a cat.
Contact Josh at Real Josh Pacheco.
I also have a 7-year-old and a wife that are available for the right cost. Number seven, a donation in your name for the worst.
Oh,
really?
Thank you for that.
Oh, thank
you. That was awesome.
It's hard to complain about a gift to charity that will undoubtedly improve lives around the world, but let's try anyway. First off, it's kind of presumptuous to decide any of your friends have fallen short of helping others. Quota over the year. Second off, it's not a cool robot to our cash or anything, which sucks.
Yeah, I think that's horrible. Absolutely. I made a donation in your name. Okay.
I'm glad I helped, you know, Bonquisha in Africa with her. You know,
yeah.
I had 30 cents of Jesus.
Laquita.
Number six, you got me the non-best-selling book about something you were interested in as a child. You know, you get him that book like, you know, Teach Yourself Bass.
Right.
Or Home Cooking for the Idiots. You know, right. Some kind of stupid book like
early
that.
Early tanning for the albino.
Yeah, exactly.
You might like that one.
Seriously, you come up with gems sometimes. You really do. I don't know where you have that hat on and where it comes from.
Working on your base albino tanning.
All right, I got the top five, Knocker, top five Christmas presents you don't want to give anyone this year. Number five.
Okay.
A subscription to a daily newspaper. Hey.
That's what I need.
I got you a yearly subscription to the Times. It'll be thrown at your door at 5 o'clock and be covered in mildew and water because
I don't care.
I don't care. Number four. I love these, but kids, your parents hate them. Homemade coupons. They don't work. They never get used, and they're not good for anything.
That is the laziest load of crap.
Isn't
ever.
It?
It is.
When your kid gives you the homemade coupons.
It's the laziest load of crap ever. I couldn't even go to the store and buy you a steak. Give me a freaking ribeye.
Yeah.
Right? Don't give me the coupons. Give me a fucking ribeye.
Oh, my God.
That would be such
a good idea.
Right? Give me 15 pounds of king crab legs.
Dad,
I don't want no coupon.
Pops, imagine if Penny showed up with a 2-pound ribeye for you and was like, here, Grandpa.
Fucking A.
Right?
Fucking
You'd
A.
You'd be like, I love you.
I love you.
And like, a glass of
scotch. What if she showed
scotch?
Up with two coupons for, hey, here's some penny love for two
I'll
and a half
fold
hour.
Your socks
here's,
for an hour.
I'll sweep the floors, Grandpa. F no, give that, me the fucking T-bone.
I want the ribeye.
Yeah, the ribeye. Top three worst presents you could give. Number three.
That.
A homemade wreath. Stop giving the homemade wreaths, okay? You got the damn stuff from your front yard, and you glued it all together, and now you want to put it on the front door. Just stop it, okay? Just stop with the homemade wreaths. Okay, number two, swag from the gift giver's place of employment. Wherever you work, don't give me the shirt where you work from,
right?
I don't know.
Hey,
do I not know?
Hey, Pops, here's some Juicy Whip swag. Hope you like it.
Hey. You know what? I disagree. He has that Juicy Whip like vest
Windbreaker.
Jacket thing.
Over, yeah.
That shit's hard as fuck, dude. I'll
Josh
fucking take that all day.
Josh, you know what I got you this year?
What? Some Pac Bell shit.
I got you an AT&T sweatshirt.
Hey.
An AT&T coffee cup.
I've seen that.
Hey.
Stuff.
And an AT&T travel mug.
Hey.
I hope you appreciate how long and how arduous.
Did you get me some of those paper towels you steal every week?
Boxes.
Oh!
I got you wet wipes and 4 boxes of paper towels.
Don't forget the glass cleaner and the stocking.
Right, and the glass cleaner.
And the stocking, right?
Merry fucking Christmas, because I love you. It's all about you,
that's
bro.
That's a fucking gift that keeps on giving, guys.
Where's the AT&T sound effect? Ding, ding, ding. Whatever. And lastly, number one, the worst present
you
can give.
Son.
Don't give
you.
Anyone a trial membership to anywhere. Hey, honey.
Jelly of the month. Club.
Hey, honey, I got you jelly. Hey, honey, I got you a 90-day free membership to 24-Hour Fitness. Hope you work that jelly fat off your ass.
Oh, you would get put on the couch in 2 minutes.
Just don't do the trial membership.
Clark, that's a gift that keeps on giving.
Unless
the whole
it's like In-N-Out, right? If you give me a trial membership to like In-N-Out or something,
A.
like my God.
You give me a $50 gift certificate to Pizza Hut?
Yeah.
I'm fucking on it.
Yeah, just don't give me one to
I'm
the gym.
On you.
I don't want gym. Don't give me gym shit. I don't want gym shit.
You're like, I'm going to go work out.
So
how many times have you seen me work out in the last 12 months? And you give me a membership to a workout club.
Wait. Yeah. What?
No. Now, this is when I need the coupon book.
BJ. Anal.
Hey.
Me
dude,
on top.
This is my, play the out music.
You
please.
On the
my,
bottom.
This is a Christmas
wow.
goddamn show. Oh, my God.
Oh my it God. Got dark real fast for you. Yeah, you're going to have fucking nightmares,
we,
Josh.
Let's pour some more tequila
doggy,
shots.
Doggy style.
We're talking about my mother like this. We need some more tequila. Thank God for the, what did Renee get us? What is that stuff called?
Cazadores.
Cazadores
tequila.
That is why Mexico is so overpopulated.
Yeah, that's right. Merry Christmas.
Stop having babies, Mexico.
Merry Christmas, man, to everybody. I want to thank all you fans. You guys have been awesome, and I hope you guys
all
stay safe.
We are living the dream, are we not?
Seriously.
We are living the dream,
you guys are fucking cool. I'm so happy I came on.
Pour the shots around. We'll have a last tequila shot here to go out for the Christmas season. I want to thank all you guys very much, our fans, our sponsors, our listeners, our supporters, our family, our friends. And
guys,
most,
I need your shot glasses.
And most
Renee,
of all, everyone that's in this room, man, especially Renee.
Where's the Jole Feliciano Feliz Navidad, bro?
Oh, man.
Renee, I want to thank you, though. Seriously, man.
Dad.
Christmas time, I want to thank you. You put up a lot with our shit on the show, and you do good for us. I appreciate it.
I love you guys, man. Thank you.
I love you, too, man.
I do. I do, man. We have a fun time. Corey, man, glad to have you back from Colorado.
Amiga, baby.
Yeah.
David. Renee, I need your shot glass, bud.
Oh, there it is right there.
Okay.
Are you trying to get Knocker's, like, going out music here?
Yeah.
Is this what you got?
Yeah! Nothing says Christmas like blind Jose Feliciano.
Let's take tequila!
Repeating the same shit over and over for 5 minutes.
Knocker, tequila shots. Here we go.
Knocker, tequila.
Tequila. Knocker, we got tequila. Here we go. Take a shot. Take a shot. Tequila. Pass one to Renee.
Orale,
that's yours,
you.
Orale.
Feliz
yours.
Navidad.
Orale.
Merry Christmas,
Feliz
everyone.
Navidad.
We love you guys all. Be safe.
Feliz Navidad.
And we'll see you guys next Tuesday. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Here we go.
I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas. I want to wish you a Merry Christmas.
You amazing.